So good evening, everybody. Now I'm going to start my presentation. This is the last session for our webinar 2020. And I hope our recording related, whatever the problem, but anyhow, let's see. Definitely you people are knowing that today, what is the topic? Definitely the medico-legal aspect and related the forensic medicine and forensic awareness for diabetic surgeons and all. But actually, before starting the program, I want to say that it is not concentrated only over the Ayurvedic surgeons and not like that. It is applicable for all the Ayurvedic doctors, okay? Whoever practicing in a personal chamber or in some institution or in some hospitals. So that's why today I am going to dedicating this topic entirely to all the Ayurvedic doctors, especially who are actually dedicating their entire medical knowledge and science for practicing. Not only that, even they are conducting several types of procedures in case of Panchakarma, even in case of any medicine related doctors and Kai Chikisha doctors or any other pharmaceuticals, Drobhaguna, Rasasastra, whatever. For everybody, it is applicable. So I am dedicating my entire topic for all the Ayurvedic doctors and all. And before starting my program, definitely it is the last session for our webinar 2020. So I'm going to give a special thanks to everybody, even to our authorities, higher authorities, our principals, our definitely all the managements and others, and even all the faculties, even from the every department, because they came and they joined this program. And not only that, the first year to fourth year, up to the all the students, okay, because they also participated, they also encouraged us as the audience. That is also very good gift for us too. Not only that, beside our colleges, whatever the other institution, JBRI, even the Kathi, Raghunath, Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya, even some other institution from other states like Karnataka, Orissa, even from Parul University, is Gujarat. So all other faculties, even other states also, whatever the institution are there, first I'm giving their grateful and I'm telling my thanks to them. And now I'm going to start the program. Now the first matter is, what is the, actually why this topic I have chosen? Okay, so first I'm showing the PPT. First place, then I'm starting my topic. Thank you. So actually, what you know, as Ayurvedic doctor, whenever we are practicing in any institution, in hospital, any nursing home, even our private practice during that time also, sometimes we are becoming very much casual. And not for that, even sometimes some institution under that where we are also practicing, this institution also sometimes not providing such of the they are not covering all of some documentations and all. For that, several cases already raised up. And from that only, I got several cases. Among them, 5 cases I have put here. Okay. And those kind of actually cases actually shoot by different people, okay, against the Ayurvedic doctor. And those kind of news teller and their published cutting I have put here, okay. So the first case I'm going to show you, and then afterwards I'm going to the next topic. So what happened, actually it is very recent case, on 2018, it has been seen in West Bengal only. The what actually happened, the patient name was Tomal, okay. He first approached one Ayurvedic doctor, name could not found, but the title got, that is the Dr. Bhattacharya. And after medications and the procedures, the patient did not get any relief. And then suddenly this patient went to the court and he sued some cases against this doctor. Usually what happened after thorough going to this over the, I mean, case studies and all, the consumer forum, they have told, yes, the doctor is actually guilty. And he has now to pay the 1 lakh rupee to the patient party. as the compensation. And because this doctor has forced to this patient to have this medications and the procedures. Just you imagine, after having this information, then we people also becoming afraid, because it is the natural thing in our whole life. We are treating several patients. 50% patients are getting sometimes relief, sometimes 20% or 30% patients are getting semi-relief, means not the total, not entire. And sometimes 10% cases we are getting what, you know, the patients are not getting relief. Sometimes they are also going somewhere else after switching over some other pathies and all. It is always happening. We could not say that we are treating the patient 100%. It's never will happen to any doctor. So if it is like that, then any patient may come, and then after giving the medicine, if they are not getting relief, that means they may do this kind of case against us, and then that we would be penalized like that. Definitely not. Definitely there is having some matter which actually has been neglected by the doctor at the very beginning of the treatment. What is this? That is the actually clue that we have to know, and based on that we will discuss over the medical legal aspect. Next, the second case I am going to tell, in case of this incident happened in Pune. What happened, the four doctors, they were running some hospital, okay, Ayurvedic hospital, but suddenly it was actually running very nicely, there was no problem, smoothly they were running. Suddenly what happened, one day one pregnant woman got expired, okay, after having some medications and all, whatever. Then and that their party, their family, they just shoot the case against this hospital. And when the case, raised up, that time it has been seen that actually the doctor, the four doctors who were running this hospital, the hospital is having no license. So then and that this case became very much, it became entirely against these doctors, and they were totally, they had the criminal file actually shoot against them, and it was the firm, firmly it was, has been putted to the, what you know, to the other, whatever the victim patient and victim persons, they got the privileges over this point only because the nursing home has not, there is having no license. Okay, the next cases, that is the two Ayurvedic doctors, they started to practice in some institution, and what happened, one patient came, okay, and she is actually female patient, and she had some malaria, okay. So that time she was suffering from malaria, and the doctor started to give her some allopathic medicines. What happened, after having such sittings and all, then the patient's conditions gradually getting deteriorated, okay, and that time they continuously requesting the doctor to change the medicine or stop the medicine, whatever, but they continuously practicing the same medicine. And at last, when the situation became totally devastated, then patient was admitted to some ICU, but it was so late. So at last what happened, just getting admission, then another the patient got expired, okay. So this is another case, that is the case 4 that I have told here. Actually I am going to tell, that is the Warangal, okay, in the usually it is Warangal, the place in the south India, especially the surrounding of the Hyderabad and all, okay. So what happened, there one lady just had some cough and cold problem, she came to one doctor, and that time the doctor has given her some medications along with some injections, and the lady's age was actually 55 years, okay. After having these injections and along with these medications, then and there what happened, suddenly she got expired. After doing the post-mortem report, it has been raised the matter that actually she actually died from the anaphylactic shock due to the adverse effect of the medications. And that time again around 6 lakhs like that money, this doctor again penalized, and along with the criminal this case also continuing. Okay, next case, that is the last case, and afterwards I'm going to tell the entire medical aspect. That is the it's also happening what the person, the victim, he also, what happened, he also having such of the epileptic conditions. So when he introduced to the doctor, that time he started to give him again some little bit mixed medicine, some Ayurvedic, some modern, like that mixed medicine. But what happened, due to the adverse effect might be, usually the patient condition becoming more devastated, and suddenly he not actually died, but his condition becoming excessively devastated, and the epileptic fit continuously coming, and it's becoming in entirely the irreversible epileptic case. Okay, the previous one I forgot to tell, that during this this lady case, I mean this 55 years case, there it has been seen that the doctor, when he started to give the anti-allergic and cold therapy and all, that time he never ever took any history of the doc, of the patient, that she had actually chronic cholesterol, along with she's having high BP, high BP, and she also having some, what you know, the heart disorder, cardiac disorder. Okay, so he did not took this information properly. Okay, so all those cases, whenever I'm going to show you, that time such of the thing is coming, that is definitely such of the things we have to maintain, only then we can restrict or get rid of some kind of medico-legal issues and all. So that's why today I'm going to concentrate my topic over the medico-legal aspect and forensic awareness for Ayurvedic surgeon. I'm Dr. Priyanka Ganguly, Assistant Professor of Shalya Tantra Department of Birla Sankar Bora Rajiv Gandhi Ayurveda Medical College and Hospital. So now the question is, what is medico-legal? It is the actually combination of the two word. First one is the medico, second one is the legal. Medico means medical aspect. Legal means definitely legal aspect. So usually medico-legal, another term is medical jurisprudence. So medical jurisprudence means juris plus prudentia. Jury means law and prudentia means knowledge. So when the knowledge of the law is actually knowledge of the law is invading the entire medical aspect, then it is called the medico-legal. Okay, so the next one is the forensic. I'm just going to describe about the top, I mean the term, afterwards I'm going through the topic. So forensic, this term also arised from the term, that is the forensis. Forensis, this term is actually the Latin word, okay, which means actually some place where the other all people are getting together, okay, just like there's some gallery like, or some like the place where all are getting together, for which reason? Usually there is having some head of the village or head of the town, and this person always would be there to justify the others all people's work, as it is legal or illegal, and after judgment that person will give punishment or any kind of relief to that villagers and all. So it is actually old method was practicing in the Latin areas and all, and afterwards the same thing also started to performing in the whole worldwide, and from this forensic word, the forensic word came. Now the question is, why forensic? Okay, medico-legal we can understand, but forensic, why it is required? Usually forensic awareness is very, very important, because there are several types of times we have seen that suddenly what happened, we are staying some buildings or some flats, okay, so what happened, suddenly the neighbors, they are calling us and they are telling, please come, there is having some urgency, some person suddenly fall down, and we know you are the Ayurvedic doctor, kindly you see if it is possible to give him or her any relief, or any if there is possible to treat him or her. What we are doing actually, Then on that, we are just running, we are entering without seeing the surrounding areas, without judging the others thing. Then and there we started to help the person. Definitely it is required. But always keep in mind, any accidental case, whenever any person is having little bit breathing problems and all, and related any heart problem and all, this is entirely different things. But whenever there is the chances of the any foul game, it can be practiced just behind the scene. That time we should be very much cautious, because we are running, we are entering, and then under we are starting to check the patient. And that time we are found that no, the patient is already expired. And what happened in between? We have touched several areas. Okay. And not only that, what happening actually, even in case of the burn case also, they are also having the chances of the people can shouting, okay, some accident happened, please sir, ma'am, you come to the recover like that. So there's also chances of any kind of foul game. So there are several types of areas we are knowing where very innocently, especially the Ayurvedic doctors are entering. But always keep in mind, as like the modern surgeon or as like the modern people, modern doctors, behind the Ayurvedic doctors, there is having no such powerful support who can rescue them from the legally. Okay, so that is the biggest problem. That's why whenever we are going anywhere for giving the patient the relief, before that we have to be very much cautious. That's why forensic awareness also, it is not the only part of the Agada Tantra or the forensic medicine. It is also the part for the Ayurvedic surgeons too, because sometimes emergency cases also they have to handling where there is a chances of the suddenly such kind of the homicidal attempt, some kind of such of the suicidal attempt too. So, by the way, now coming to the next point, that is the inquest. Yes, usually inquest means that is the interrogation, okay, or asking some questions. Okay, so usually inquest, whenever it is partaken in the court, okay, so usually it has been seen that all kind of deaths or all kind of cases, okay, where the people are victimized or the patients, normally patients, whenever they are having any such of disorder, all cases is not required of this inquisition or the inquest. Okay, such of the cases are there where especially the doctors, when are going to check the patient and there is having such suspicious matter, that maybe there is having, maybe it is not the natural way the incident has been occurred. That means that naturally some pathological cases occurred, or the naturally some death occurred. If it is not like that, it is seeming to something else, that time usually the inquest is very, very important. Especially there is having such of the cases I'm going to tell. So in that cases, usually the doctor who is actually checking or the examining the patient, the patient who related the case actually should over the court and all. For that, the summons of the witness usually sending to the doctors. Okay. And that time as the expert witness, because there is having the two kinds of witness, that is the expert, another one is the common witness, common people who are just becoming the witness of any murder case, killing case or whatever. So in case of the summons of the witness, whenever it is sending to the doctors, then they should be very firm about their knowledge and they should tell the entire things. Like one example I'm giving, as Ayurvedic doctor, usually it is our one kind of negligency that whenever any patients are coming without checking their BP, then and that we are giving Lavan Bhaskara. So many doctors I have seen yet, okay, without checking their BP, they are giving Chitragadi Vati, they are giving Lavan Bhaskara Churna. In case of South, we have seen the cases, in front of us, of 2 to 3 cases, that after giving Chitragadi Vati, the person who is already having high BP, it is also may deal a very devastated conditions. Then another is raising their BP. So what happened there, that much problem not created, but in future, who can tell that any BP patient, it may devastated for them. And that time, if any case will be shoot there, that time we have to go also, and that time as a doctor we have to give the Ayurvedic doctor, that time we have to explain the exactly the what you know pharmacological inventions of the entire Lavan Bhaskar Churna or Chitra Kadivarti and how it's working. So entire thing, their description, everything by the doctor, they have to described and explained over their court and all. So in case of that, the inquest, usually it has been seen in which cases it is usually impalatable. In case of any homicidal cases, any domestic accident, in case of sudden death, because sudden death, it may be any normal death, okay, sometimes natural death, sometimes it is not the natural death. There may be some other alcoholism, drugs, poisons, and death during operation. Okay. In case of industrial accident, allegation of negligences and a doubtful doctor. Sometimes if the patient's also having some doubt about the doctor that no, he is quack, he is not having the proper certificates. Okay. So they definitely may issue the, case to the court. And any kind of criminal abortion and infant death. So now coming to the IPC, that is we are doing the Indian Penal Code. Yes, usually it has been told in Indian Penal Code that is any omission or commission, whatever, it is not actually guilty or it is not as the crime. But when it is becoming crime, when there is having the accompanied with the guilty mind. Okay, so based on that, it has been seen that is especially for the doctors who are maximum time, okay, even for Ayurvedic doctors also, they are penalized in case of malpractice or in case of the negligency cases. That is actually section IPC section 304 and 304A. 304 actually it is non-bailable. There it has been told that the person who is actually not intentionally doing, but they are already negligency occurred, I mean, or done by the doctor, but it is not intentionally, but it is getting the suspension as like the non-bailable. Okay, sometimes there is the chances of the 2 years of they have to be custody in the jail and all. Not only that, even in case of the 304, this is actually bailable. It has been seen that if the patient is still alive and they are also having no intention of the this kind of negligency or from the from behind of this doctors, then definitely also the doctor would be penalized for some money or for some days they have to be in the jail, but still it is bailable. Okay, and that's why there are several various time different gadgets also came. So latest gadget I have got from the net and I put here, if anybody is interested, they can go through the internet and they may see that there are different kind of sections along with their all the rules regulations has been described yet. In Ayurvedic science also there has been told that 28 deadly punishment. Okay, that several peoples, they are also not having, especially in Ayurvedic field, people are also very less people are knowing that in Garuda Sangita, it has been told that it is not actually mentioning the after death only this kind of punishment would be given. No, actually the previous time, this kind of punishment was practicing. That's why small so that's why the that time world was quite safe and quite better than now. But what happened throughout the days and also the entire this punishment totally changed. Now the criminals are not getting punishment instead of normal. It is Garuda Sangita, there it has been told that among the this 28 punishment, such of the punishment, especially the Shukra Mukham, there it has been told the person who actually just avoiding the practice or avoiding their entire duty okay, or they are not performing their duty properly, for them, usually for them, the punishment is to crash and dormition. Okay. Afterwards, there are several punishment is there, but I have seen which is quite similar with the, our profession, that is Ashita Patram. There also has been told the sharp flogging. Okay, for the person who is having the tendency of especially the fault, I mean, they are giving some false witness. Okay, whatever not happened or whatever not occurred, they are giving some false statement to the court and all. For them also, this sharp flogging has been told yet. And then there is also having the avichi. This is also just making the persons entirely continuously, I mean, just throwing them again and again, and just make them just like the dust and all. So like that entire description is there, where this punishment is given to that kind of person who are not doing their duties in their field properly. So it is applicable for everybody, not only for doctors, even it's applicable for common people too. So I'm just now over this topic, I'm just going to tell that the Aparichit one movie is there, I think the South Indian movie. There also the Garud Sangeeta related, this entire matter has been followed up. So it is a thriller, and it is a very, very nice movie actually. So if anybody will go through that, they will feel like, they will understand exactly the applications of the punishment in Ayurveda that time. Anyhow, so I'm coming to the next one, that is the first duty of the Ayurvedic doctors. Whenever we are going to start our practice, first we have to check our documentation, which is very, very important. First, we have to see that our documents, if there is having any registration or not. Registered medical practitioners is very, very important. Before getting registration, better not to start any practice, because any case will be happen means any mishap, nothing actually, you are running smoothly. Suddenly one day one mishap occurred, then what happened? Then and that the documentation would be the main law, and that time you'd be sued by the court. So better after getting registration, you should go. Otherwise, you will be deemed as like the quacks. Not only that, there is the chances of some people, especially in the village, some people are practicing there with the fake medical certificate. And not only that, even it has been seen some doctors also helping to make this kind of certificate and helping to other friends to practice somewhere else. So this is not acceptable. Next one is, yes, this is very important. That is, whenever you are starting to do any practice in shop, in an institute or any hospital or any nursing home, wherever, there the proper documentation also would be there. Not ours only, these institutions also. Usually for the shop, there the license and professional tax should be clear, and to the municipality or municipal corporation, their entire documentation would be there. Otherwise, anytime, any kind of negligency case, if it will come, just like accident, like also, that is also would go against to you if your institution also not having the proper license or not having the proper acts and all. Not only that, even the NABA, that is the National Accreditation, this kind of accreditation is very important for the any nursing home, any hospital, especially the hospital and the health institution. So for the Ayurvedic establishment, there is one already the PDF form is available. There are the development of minimum standards of the clinical establishments in Ayurveda, that's you people will get from the net only. I just gave the picture from there only. Now coming to the biomedical vast rules. Yes, most of the cases it has been seen the doctors, they are practicing, especially the Shara Sutra. There have even some kinds of any abscess drainage, any kind of wound therapy, everything they are doing. They are cleaning, they are whatever the linen, they are whatever the curtains and the waste products. They are just throwing without any proper packaging and all. Okay, what and sometimes it has been seen the doctors. Usually, they are reciting some not commercial, some residential place also. They are starting to do like that. What happened actually? Every day they are doing no problem, but suddenly one day, if it will be noticed by the corporations or municipality, they will charge against you because they will think that something foul place is going on, because that's why that much blood stain we got from this dustbin and all. So any day, any time, any problem may arise. So that's why biomedical, whatever the waste related rules are already told there, in based on that, there some other pollution certificate and related the biomedical waste certificate also better to have from the proper municipality or for corporations or some other place which is related to that. Okay, and definitely another thing is from the Ayurvedic doctor, it has been seen usually the waste products are actually their biomedical time. That means usually there is having some little bit metals like arsenic, lead, or the mercuries and all. So even sometimes the linen, sometimes cottons are there. For that also, just throwing them separately, there is having different dustbin. That is also sometimes not maintaining properly. In future, for any kind of inspection and all, that is also making such of the problem or hazard just against your practice also. So be careful when you are practicing in your chamber or in such institution. There, the proper biomedical waste rules are maintaining or not, that should be followed up. Next one, it is very important, that is the secrecy. Whenever you are going to see the patient, yes, their secrecy is very, very important, their privacy. Because the person came, whatever the problem they are sharing, if you are going to share their personal problem to others, then the patient can show the case against you, definitely. So always you have to keep the secrecy. But sometimes this case never go against you. Which case? Whenever the patient already suffering any kind of mental illness, like they are having some paranoia of any problem, you and after doing this consultation, you understood the person is having such of the risk factor, because the person having the tendency to kill or to murder, to hurt somebody else. Not only that, even if you are thinking that the person is having some neurological problems, having some diminished of the vision. So what happened if the patient is he is actually working in such of the factory where the very sharp or very heavy sharp instruments are continuously they have to handle, or he has to handle, there is a chances of suddenly accident, and that also would be the very fatal for him. So in that cases, you may consider this case to not complain, to tell their authority to take some precaution. Not only that, even the person who is having some skin disorder, which is contagious, or just a recent case, that is the COVID-19 also. If you are knowing the person is already suffered for the coronaviruses, and they are suppressing the things as just spreading the disorder to the society, definitely you are having this liability to inform the even sometimes it is required to the police, sometimes the health ministers and related corporations or municipality, whatever. Okay, so next one, that is the proper documentation. Yes, whenever we are taking the patient, most of the cases actually we are not documenting properly. So many people are coming, and that time we are just okay, what happened? Okay, even their past history, we are also not taking. There previously, this case I already explained, where the lady, 55 years, she got expired because her entire history has not been taken properly. She is having high BP, that has not been taken properly. Her respiratory rate not taken properly. Even her having some heart problem. So like that condition, any systemic conditions which may afterwards may cause some severity, and that may go against the doctor if any mishap is occurring. That's why whenever the patient is coming, not only the chief complaint, even their history, even their whatever, what kind of their medicine taking, even sometimes it has been seen that people are having the tendency to have some drugs, drug abuse. So in that cases also, we are not taking their drug addictions and all properly. So what happened? Today one patient came, I have given some medicines, I have not taken the history properly, and the next day suddenly after having the medicines, not having the medicine, actually after having the overdose of such of drugs, the patient got expired. And what happened? Next day, the patient party came and started to allegate me that you were the doctor, for from you the medicine first he has taken and then he got expired. If I am having the exactly this proof that yes, this patient is having the tendency to have this kind of addictions or having such of the drugs, then it will help us for our further recovery of this kind of cases. Okay, but most of the cases we are actually avoiding. Not only that, it is very important the consent and consent. Why? First case I told, this Tomal case, there the person came and then they started to give in the medicine and all, and after a sudden something happened, nothing happened, no outcome came, and he went for this case. Actually, always we have to think that when a patient is coming to consult us, that time he is coming willingly. That time nobody can raise their question that there is required of any agreement. Okay, consent means one kind of free agreement or the permission from the patient, right? But whenever I am starting to give him any medications or any procedures, that is actually under the question, because next time or whenever any situation or any devastated condition may occur where the patient party may say that I have given the medicine forcefully. That's why it has been recommended, even doing Panchakarma, even doing Shara Sutra, even doing Agni Karma, any kind of Anushastra Karma, or even giving, nowadays that much problem is getting, so before giving even little bit medicine also, better to have one consent form signature from the patient, not only the patient, even from their some witness from the patient party and from on the behalf of doctors even. Okay, because sometimes the witness also can deny the entire case. And always keep in mind, this consent form should be written in the local language along with English. Not only English, along with English, along with regional language should be there. Otherwise, sometimes in the case, the patient party may withdraw the entire matter that, actually, sir, you know, it has been written in English. We could not read the English. We could not understand the English. So this person, whatever written, we just, by forcing, we just signed. Like that thing they may challenge. So that's why better always keep the both or bilingual, especially the regional language should be there. Then the person could not charge like that way. Okay. And okay, so this is the very important thing. And next one is, yes, always there need of evidence. In this video, we may see most of the cases, the several institutions, several hospitals, only doctors are getting beaten by the patient's party. And that time, usually, it has been seen the other, some other workers and all, they are actually few of these areas. Because who are ready, who are being ready to get beat by some person? But what happened? We should keep some CCTV. Because sometimes what happened, whenever the patient party are entering such a they are under, before doing any wrongdo and all, they are always thinking, no, if I am doing anything, this videos and everything would be caught there. And there is a chances of the suddenly arresting by the police and all. So this kind of fear also may come. And before doing any devastated steps, they are becoming a little bit cautious. So CCTV is very important. Not only that, even after doing any this kind of assault and all, that is also helping to find out the what you know, this kind of persons or the criminals or this kind of people who are actually beating the doctors. And next time, then we can restrict their entrance of the or entry to the institution or the clinics. Having several cases, and it has been told the medical negligence actually it is concentrating over different sector. Like if the doctor, that may be Ayurvedic doctor or modern doctor, whatever, if they are giving any wrong medicine with wrong doses. In our Ayurveda, it has been seen we are having not such of the standard. Sometimes we are giving the same medicine twice, sometimes we are giving thrice. In case of the Tarunavastha, that is called the acute condition, whatever the medications we are using, in case of the chronic avastha or the jina avastha, I mean chronic situation, they are also giving the same medicines. Sometimes the doses are also not properly done. In such cases, there is a chances of the suddenly there would be actually nowadays still that kind of problem not arise, but I still remember one case in South India. There one person continuously taking the rasa ushadhi, okay, and after having he had some systematic problem along with the kidney. His kidney already it was a polycystic kidney and all, and that time he was continuously having such of the rasa ushadhi at his stretch for 1 year and all, and the doses also he has not maintained properly. Afterwards we got the news that is the by the kidney necrosis and all, something happened and he died. Actually, he also actually was the Ayurvedic doctor. Becoming Ayurvedic doctor also, he had not maintained exactly the doses and all. So that's why the proper medications and their doses, their standardization is important. Otherwise, in future, no one can say that any of us would be assaulted by this kind of problem and all. Next one is the definitely the breaking needle while injecting. Especially Ayurvedic doctors are not injecting, but so many cases we have seen the more Ayurvedic doctor who are practicing in nursing home and hospital, they are doing. So that time also if it is tucking during these injections, this needle, that also would be under the medical negligence. Too tight plaster cast, definitely there is a chances of the suddenly what due to the tight plaster, it may cause the lack of circulations. And whenever the circulations would be the obstructed, there is the chances of the necrosis along with the gangrene. And then the last choice is the amputation. So definitely the patient party will not leave you along with their sweet, sweet words. Definitely they will try to beat you. So that's why be careful about any kind of tight plaster casting and all. Next one is the operation to wrong side, definitely. Barger disease, over the right leg, you went and you started to do it over the left leg. Operations are entirely, you have amputated. Definitely, it is the biggest medical negligence. Next one is the operation on the wrong person. Okay, so that's why, just to avoid this kind of negligence, the documentation, again, I'm telling, documentation is very, very important. And their identification. If you could not identify the two person along with their all the features, for that only forensic awareness is important. Those are both thing is actually correlated, that's why. So for the identification purpose, this one also very, very important to segregate two person before doing any operation and or giving any wrong medicine and all. Even the operation to the wrong organ, okay, right side of the kidney, you went for the left side of the kidney. Definitely, it's a big problem. You went for the erupted the tooth, suddenly the molar tooth, you did it for the premolar tooth. Definitely, it's a problem. Next one is the amputation of the wrong limb and toe. I already described. Next, the leaving the swab surgical instruments inside the body cavity. Definitely, it's the medical negligence. Next one is the hot water bag buns. Sometimes it also be happen that whenever we are giving the patient this hot water for the compression and all, that time we are not at all checking their temperature, and after giving also how much time it should be compressed, that also not mentioning or not checking properly, and if it is causing any kind of burn, for especially for any unconscious patient or coma patient and some other patient who is not having in the proper mental state, there is also raising the matter, that is the medical negligence. Another one is a radiation burns. Yes, it has been seen yet in such the same case I have seen in Tata Mumbai also, one case actually I observed there little bit burn was little bit much more. Okay, so it is actually there, they are quite professional, but sometimes it happen, and that is also whenever happening, then there is a chances of the patient party that they may shoot the case. Okay, so be careful about that. And another one is the anesthetic mishap. Yes, for Ayurvedic doctors also, when I have got to that during especially the high anal fistula and all, during what happened, not only that, even some aged patient who is having very low mental strength and all, for them whenever you are going to inject the 2% lignocaine, okay, inhale as locally, suddenly some neurogenic shock, this patient is becoming little bit, what you know, there some shock may occur, and then that the emergency may occur. So in that cases it may be a very very dangerous for your career. For that only, sometimes it is preferable to go for the spinal anesthesia. But in case of that also, the medicine is supervised by the, actually under the vision of the proper anesthetic. Okay, the matter is, most of the cases it has been seen the Ayurvedic doctors, they are performing the Shara Sutra without proper institution. They are doing it inside their residential clinic. There is having no NABL accreditation. There is having no waste management act properly. They are having no such of the papers and all. And even they are starting to give materials. Okay, so there is a chances of the sudden complication that actually just one incident is enough to just give just push us to the jail. Next one is the mismatch blood transfusion. It's also very very important matter for any kind of doctors, because especially it has been seen the blood group matching, the actually the ABO, this blood match, after doing blood match also, even the Rh factor, after having the proper matching also, it has been seen suddenly the, whenever the sister is going to introduce this blood, transfusion this blood, suddenly this mismatch occurred. Okay, just AB or like the A positive, and she actually not seen it properly, that is the A negative like that. So it is a life threatening problem. So if it is like that, then no one can survive you from this dangers. Not only that, even there are different matters I have put for especially the Ayurvedic doctors and Ayurvedic surgeons. Sterilization definitely is the matter. If your instrument is not properly sterilized, definitely after having the operations, if there is having the chances of the secondary infections, patient is liable to do the complaint against you. Okay, so that's why always try to make clean and sterilization should keep for the instruments. Next one is that whatever the instruments using, that that's sharpness would be obtained properly, because sometimes the hesitation, sometimes we are going to what the removing or excised out some hernial sac, that time continuously second time, third time, fourth time, we are just trying to cut this sac and it is not getting, because this instrument is not proper. Again and again hesitation marks may cause the hemorrhage. Suddenly there is a chances of the hemorrhage, and it is taking much more time. So for that also, it is very very dangerous for the health of the patient during the operation table. Even sometimes it has been seen that pre-operative checkup It's also not done by the doctor, Ayurvedic doctor specially properly. Whenever we are going for any kind of Sharashutra operation, there should be checked the blood properly, because before doing also we have to be confirmed that the patient's hemoglobin rate, their TCDC, ESR, is proper or not. If there is having the they are having the hemoglobin rate less, that time also I have seen so many doctors are going for some operations. HP percentage less means there is a chances of less healing. Ropan and Shodhan, this property would be disturbed if the hemoglobin rate is less. So there is a chances of, again, secondary infections. So please avoid this kind of hurry. Better first you check the TCDC, ESR, hemoglobin rates along with their blood match also important, because during operation table, there is, if any kind of emergency will be occurred, then you have to give the relief to the patient, otherwise this person will die. And if it is like that, then you have to keep ready the blood, definitely blood. Before storage the blood, you have to check their blood groups out. Even there is having any STD, any kind of sexually transmitted disease or not, that you have to be confirmed. Along with that, definitely this is also important, their entire PP, any systemic disorder, any heart problem. If there is having any evidence that the person is having already the weak heart or any cardiomegaly and anything like that, just don't go for this kind of operations. Better the, there are several exception also there. Okay, then we can obtain based on their pre-operative checkup. Like one example I'm giving, just without properly checking the fistula, where it is situating, then in that just doing the blood test, sometimes that's also we are not doing, we are going for the fistulectomy or especially this one, Sharashutra ligation. We have to see where it is situating, because multiple time probing, that is also may cause such of the shock to the patient. So that's why fistulogram, it is recommended. Very, very less doctor especially in Bengal, I have seen they are doing. Next one, I already told the consent, witness and data maintaining. Okay. And another one, that is the electrolyte balance. Yes. Whenever it is not only the surgeon, because it also has been recommended that sometimes, some cases, any skin disorder, sometimes we are not going through by this Jaluka and all. Sometimes if it is required simultaneously, the Birechana Karma also, we can go for that. Whenever any skin disorder is partaking. Because it has not been mentioned that the Ayurvedic doctor only they could just entitle in only one system. So whenever it is happening, that time we have to be very much cautious, because Vaman and Birechana, that is also causing sometimes electrolytic imbalance. Okay. So in case of that, we should be very much cautious, because Birechana, it has been seen the 20 times, sometimes 25 times, continuously this Birechana is occurring. And for that cases, we should maintain their exactly potassium level properly, otherwise and they becoming very much dehydrated. So it is very, very important to maintain their hydration part also, otherwise it may cause such of complication, and definitely it is dangerous for us. Post-operative care also important. After operation, then and there, the attitude of some doctors I have seen, they are telling, who are you, I don't know, like that. No. After having the operation, especially the Sharashutra changing, that is also I have seen a big problem in Bengal, where after doing, they are not properly doing any changes. Okay, after 7 days, their changes is required. Okay, the same patient, just two weeks before, one patient called me, and he also having the same problem. He also complained to me that somewhere he has done this, the same thing, Sharashutra from somewhere else. Now it's becoming just a chronic problem. Now they have not changed the Sutra, and continuously there is having the passes, bleeding and all. So you see how the our malpractice actually disturbing the people's life. Okay, so this why, that's why post-operative care also very important, and proper dressing, that is also important to avoid any further infections. Okay, even their entire monitoring of the BP, pulse rate, everything also important. Okay. Next one is the lab report, pre and post operative. So many people are telling, yes, we are doing only Prakriti or constituent just checking. So there is no record of any pre or post operative laboratory test. Yes,
I am agreed with you, but the matter is nowadays people are becoming very much intelligent because they are always going through the Google. Okay, they are searching everything, so they are having less, I mean, faith over the classical and all. But whenever we are in this field, we have to be very much cautious about our own fame and fortune. Okay, definitely, whenever we are going to diagnose the patient, we have to diagnose the patient with the all the concept of prakriti. But for the safety purpose, for the safety purpose, because in future no one knows that any mishap will occur, that time this laboratory report actually will help you to get rid of this kind of cases. So only for that reason only, better to go for some medical, the modern medical laboratory test, just for the showcasing purpose. Sometimes it is diagnostic also, it is helping definitely, but better you go along with that. But you diagnose along with your constituent or prakriti concept, no problem. But all those documentary purpose, better you keep all laboratory test too. Next one is the storaging of the, it has been seen the properly we are also giving some medicines, but their storaging is not done properly. So sometimes some people are actually misusing this one. Some patients party also, they are mixing along with some other medicines or some steroids or some illegal or the expired medicines, and they may show the case that yes, the doctor has given me that kind of medicine. So just avoiding this kind of conditions also, better to give the proper storage or the proper sealed medicine. If you are preparing yourself, no problem, but the sealing would be proper. And sometimes it is also helping. Sometimes there is a chances the patient may remove it and again they can mix up along with some other things. But still, from your part, you would be perfect. Otherwise, this matter would be a big issue from the court and all. In case of the medications, whenever you are preparing, that time the expiry dates and the batch number, better to mention. If you are having your own company GMP certified, it's very good. Otherwise, if you are making yourself, also better to discuss with the any consumer forum or any drug act related law person how to proceed before giving any medications, because nowadays it's becoming a big issues. And now if it is not, still not big issues, but in future no one knows when and how it will invade your practice life. Next one is the adverse drugs reaction. Yes, that I already explained. Sometimes people are having such of the high BP. People are giving them lavan vaskara chunna, chitra kadi bati. Not only that, it has been seen the person is having already pitta aggravated. In that cases also, we are giving sometimes it has been the ingashta chunna and all. Even sometime it has been seen the person already pitta already aggravated that much, we are going for the agni karma. Okay, even in the excessive hot season, there is avoid, it has been told the avoid of any kind of agni karma. Still also we are going for that. Not only that, even it has been seen the person already kapha aggravation is there, still for them we are not going for other raktamokshana therapy, we are directly going along with the jaloka. Okay, there is the chances again kapha aggravation surrounding the skin or surrounding these areas. Sometimes this also causing the delay of the actually survive. Okay, these conditions, it has been seen actually jaloka is very much safe treatment, but still there is having some delay of the healing and all. Not only that, even another thing I also recommend here, the Shiraveda. It has been seen that before doing the Shiraveda, definitely the CTBT should be checked. Clotting time, bleeding time, it is very, very important, because in South also 3 to 4 cases we have seen just in front of us that suddenly the patient became unconscious, or suddenly fainted due to the excess amount of the bleeding, and suddenly there is having very there is having even hemoglobin rate also less. So in that cases we should not go for the Shiraveda. So that's why before doing any kind of Shiraveda, should go for proper CTBT, and especially the air hemoglobin rates and the hemocrits, RBC counts, everything should be checked properly. Okay, otherwise it may in future lead to you to jail. Next one is the performing the modern surgery. Definitely. Actually, what happened, modern surgery also you may do, but along with some, especially the modern surgery, under them you may do. Okay, that's along and entirely individually we may not perform, because this time the modern surgeon may raise the question that if you are going to do the hydrocele operations, or if you are going for any herniectomy, hernioplasty, hernia, or a few whatever, appendectomy, whatever, do you have any such of references? Yes, we are having such of references for herniectomy, not herniectomy, for hernia. For that, we are having the explanation about the Agnikarma, but we could not give any description about the exact whatever the surgical operations they are doing. These operations descriptions we could not produce that time. So that's why better by collaborations with the modern surgeon as the first hand assistant, definitely. Ayurvedic surgeon, they may go from, otherwise any mishap will better to give a big trouble for your career. Next one is the referring the hospital. Yes, most of the cases it has been the doctor is having that tendency not to refer the patient whenever they are seeing this is becoming very critical conditions or very severe conditions. Still that time also they are gripping the patient along with them, so it is also very bad habit. And that's why better whenever we are thinking that it be serious, it, there is a chances of the sudden fatality of the patient, we should refer to the proper hospital. This is not defaming. Better referring to the other institution, it is actually helping to, the patient, that is also faming you afterwards. That is actually good habits. Not only that, whenever you are any emergency cases, your institution and others, they are definitely oxygen supply and ambulance service. This kind of a very emergency service should be there. Otherwise, there is a chances of the sudden any kind of shoe against any bill accreditation and all by them. Next one is that is the definitely whenever that I already described previously that prerequisitions why it is important. Even OT medicine, yes, sometimes we are applying the, what you know, that is betadine before doing any operations, whatever the parts savings, after doing the parts savings, we are just cleaning and wrapping the places along with the betadine and the surgical space. But sometimes the modern people also may raise the question, why you people having no things, you people could not use some Ayurvedic drugs just as a replacement? Definitely, because we people are not at all that much interested to do any research work. That's why the problem is going on. What happened? It has been proved that previously also it has been seen that in case of the mummy, when the mummy was made up by the, actually prepared by the Egypt people, they are also using the honey for the healing and open purpose. Okay, it is also helping the purifications and enter the healing purpose. In case of the Ayurveda, whenever we are using this honey for any vrana or after dressing or cleaning any abscess or any wound, this is also helping, just working as like just like the antibacterial is having the property, along with is having the shodhana property, as well as the haridra, that is also antibacterial, antifungal properties there. So mixing along with the haridra powder and along with this honey, if we are draping the entire areas, okay, there is the sometimes problem is there, it is becoming little bit sticky. So for the cleaning or draping purpose, we can little bit mix up the water and this haridra at first, and as the post operative cases we may go along with madhu. Okay, another thing also I want to mention here, that is the Trifala Kashayam. It is also three doshanashak, and this is also very good for antibacterial cases. So that is also prakshalan purpose or the cleaning, dressing purpose. Why should go always along with this metrogel and all? That time also as a replacement, we may use just Trifala Kashayam. And just for the, whenever betadine gel we are using, just be, removing it and you start to use the little bit madhu and just to see the result. Okay. So that kind of improvise we may do, but most of the cases the doctors are not that much interested. Shara Sutra in hospital, that I already explained, that if any time any hazard will come, definitely they will shoot the case against you if you are doing any this kind of operations in any residence or this kind of clinic. So better you go for the proper hospital or the nursing home or such of institution which has having some license for operations and all. Next one, local spinal anesthesia, I already explained, and precaution for Shiravada, that's also I have told. This is very important thing, the Jaluka. So it I have seen in several times that people are actually malpracticing along with Jaluka. One Jaluka, I never ever seen any reference from any book that it has been mentioned the Jaluka after using for one person, it can be recommended, it can be used for other person. It is entirely the malpractice. I am just always requesting all the doctors that always do the safe practice. Please do the safe practice, because you are not knowing the patient is having any HIV positive or having any such of the contagious diseases, any eczema, psoriasis, whatever. Better, whenever you are using one Jaluka for one patient, try to keep it for a long, even if the Jaluka is getting expired also, let it die, but still don't use for just getting money the same Jaluka to other patients. Okay, otherwise in future also it may cause some problem against you. Agni Karma, during that time also it has been sometimes an neurogenic shock also sometimes occurs. So before that, better to explain the entire thing to the patient slowly. If it is required, the demo also you may do. Afterwards, you may go for the entire session. That would be better. Next one is the classical Agni Karma replaced by the Agni Karma, Agni acupuncture and needle and cautery. That is also another point, that is acupuncture. What is the exact concept? We people are not knowing. But I am having the degree over this one. That's why I am knowing actually acupuncture is working over the yin and yang concept. But several times, as I have seen, the just some Ayurvedic doctors, they are using some needles and they are just introducing some points and they are starting to cautery. They are just connecting the cautery to give such of the, they are telling it is one kind of Agni Karma. I'm just asking from which references they got this kind of thing. So what happened, usually acupuncture needles, their thickness is entirely different and it is actually connected with not cautery machine, it is connected with the tense machine. Okay, that's why their entire electric waves is maintaining properly. So if it is like that, we are doing means by the name of the Agni Karma, in future no one can resist us to go to the jail if any mishap is occurring in the world. Next one is the misconception, Marma therapy. So many people are telling, we are the Marma guru, he's come, we are giving some knowledge. But in our science, it has been mentioned properly, the Baikallakar Marma. Yes, it has been told that there is any kind of pressure or any kind of malpractice also, or any kind of injury that may also leading the patient to as being the paralyzed and all. So whatever the therapy is going on, especially be cautious about this Baikallakar Marma and all, Saddha Pranahara Marma and all. So before giving pressure over there, better to know the entire anatomical positions and better to avoid those marmas before doing such of malpractice. Next one is the medical certificate. Yes, actually time is going on and my topic is very large. And I'm just trying to make it a little bit shorter. Otherwise, it will take much more time. So for the medical certificate, definitely it's important. Whenever we are giving the medical certificate to the patient, always keep in mind we have to sign properly along with our, we have to give the seal, proper seal. Otherwise, what happened, sometimes it has been seen the criminal, some criminal tendencies there, some person who just get rid of any criminal case. Sometimes they may forgery your entire medical certificate, and they may write down that this doctor has given, I mean, they can rename your name that this doctor already given me this medical certificate that during this murder case, actually I was ill. And then afterwards, she has given me this medical certificate. So there is a chances of the forgery. So better not only signature, try to give your proper registration and along with this seal. Because why it is important, the handwriting expert, they will find out the actual flaw. But if there is not having the proper signature along with the seal, then there is a chances of the again medical legal issues. Telemedicine is also nowadays becoming very popular. People are doing without knowing properly the rules and regulations. That is also would be the in future a big problem, because there is already mentioned that you may consult the patient properly over through this virtually, through this video conference, telephonic and whatever. But if you are not that much confident, just because you are not seeing the patient in front of you, there is a lively sitting in front of you. It is not like that. The person is entirely devoid of any contact of you. It is just the virtually he is presenting everything. So if you are not that much confident, don't give medicine. Okay, don't give any medicine, because it also may arise some kind of problem. Better to ask the patient to wait somewhere. Otherwise, better to get some other reports. Be confirmed, then only send medicines. Otherwise, it also causes some problem. And next one is the practice of the medicine Ayurveda modern. Definitely same question several times, several areas came. Yes, I always prefer the safe treatment or safe always say practice, okay? Because 5 years or 6 years I am practicing along with Ayurveda, Ayurvedic medicines, along with their all intervention, their all pharmacological reactions I know. I think at least little bit I know, but the modern there, if any hazards will be occurred, how to survive the patient, how to recover the situation, that much knowledge sometimes we are not having. But we are having also, sometimes there is the chances of the some cases, whenever it is arising, that time definitely the question will raise and the finger will be pointed towards us. So if Ayurveda is having such of the medicines, then try to little bit avoid the modern. If it is not possible, then better just take some suggestions from doctors who is modern medicine doctor, and along with them, better you prescribe the medicine, not by yourself only. Next one, definitely the steroid is the main issue. Sometimes steroid is not mentioned in our science, in our references. So whenever the people are mixing the steroid to just expedites the action of suddenly within one night, the patient got a relief from the asthmatic bronchial asthma. And also like that magic, whenever we are starting to do that, can be very much cautious, because sometimes these medicines also making so much questionable towards the patient too. Several times I have seen the patients also asking me, you know, madam, that doctor giving me this kind of medicine, I am going to some drug development institution to check this medicine's actual ingredients. Like that, so many things directly the patients also told me about some other doctor. So be very much cautious to mixing up any steroids. Okay, this is becoming a big problem. This is not the problem for the modern science, because they are having the references. Okay. And in case of the prakriti-based treatment, now it's not the problem, but for the practices or sometimes the negligence, it may cause, because I previously told any pitta aggravated cases or any rakta dushita cases, we could not give the same pitta aggravating medicines and all. If you are giving, that may cause such of the problems. Okay, there are several kind of examples out there which may cause this kind of problem. So that's why better for the safe practice, give the medicines based on their prakriti. Just avoid any hazards in future. Yes, they are, for us, they are different. I'm just going to shorten the case because it will take more than half an hour. Just I'm making it shorter, okay? So appearance of the case is that maybe sometimes the people actually survived, sometimes the person is going to be dying, and sometimes the person already dead. Like that cases may come. For us, most of the cases, we have seen the survived case, otherwise the dying cases are coming. Dead person usually not called, actually this kind of call we are not getting from the patient party, okay? But still little bit the knowledge if you are having, that will help us. Like usually for the crime scene investigation, it is very important because evidence experts are there who are actually taking the pictures, the surrounding areas, whatever the any instruments or any kind of weapons, whatever used or it is actually not, presenting that it is entirely missing everything. Even the footprints, their hand, their fingerprints, okay, even the lip prints, everything, all kind of surrounding investigations are done by, carried out by them. But sometimes what happened? Suddenly any foul thing is going on and some person who is having some criminal motive, they are calling you, sir, please come. And see, just case suddenly she fall down, and you went and you saw the there is having continuously profuse bleeding. Okay, and the hemorrhage is partaking from there. Entirely the skull bone is already totally fractured and all. So something happened there. You, if you are not looking surrounding, that you have not seen the exactly a hammer, just a hammer or a very heavy object is just. Residing there just very near about, and there is having some blood stain without seeing anything, then and that you went, okay just we should help, like that you started to help. Them and along with that is the chances of to hit the person already they have what framing the cases, and better to touch anything, better to do anything, call the police. Without informing the police, police will tell you what, because sometimes for ayurvedic doctor, sometimes laws also not standing along with us. Police also may ask us, maybe we are the partner of the same criminal person. So that's why the physical examination is very important. Whenever any patient, even in the survived case or in any life, I mean the person is still alive and all, whenever they're coming, we have to check the properly their entire thing, like their actually head to toe, better to check, but it is not possible entirely, but sometimes we have to check, like there, first of all, there are any scar marks. It is very important if there is having any scar, what kind of scar, because here I'm showing one thing, because actually each and every scar, they are having such of the history behind them, okay? So that's why scar, if you are not checking properly, it will give you a big punishment in future, because sometimes it happened a patient came but you have neglected that there is having some bite mark, you started to do the dressing and all, after suddenly after returning back again something happened, the patient what again bitten, again something happened and the patient got expired. Definitely the police, even the court will ask you, being an ayurvedic doctor or being a doctor, you have not checked properly the scar, it was the bite or there is having some bitten laceration and all, you have not seen yet. So that's why be very much cautious whenever the patient is coming, be careful and just look them and check them properly, because each and every scars are different. In case of the puncture wound, that is different. In case of the abrasion, whenever any suspicious scar you will see, then and there you write down, you just document it, and you should interrogate the patient the exact reason, and that one also better as the documentary you should write down, because in future anything would be happen, case will go against you, okay? Not only that, even gunshot injury, even case of the any traumatic laceration over the face, even don't do like that. Sometimes it also happened, the patient came and they are telling, no, doctor, I am have actually my husband just beaten me like that. But which scar actually she is showing you, you are not going to see properly. Suddenly are thinking, yes, this is the real case. No. Sometimes they may show you the keloids. Keloids also what happened. This is a very, I mean, previously something, some accident or some infections also may occur afterwards also. It is also the one kind of, layer after layer of the wrinkles of the skins is causing this kind of scar, which is called the keloids. Even after post scar mark also may live over the body, that is the cholecystectomy, cystectomy or appendicitis and all. If you are not identifying or segregating both of them, if they are telling anything and if you are just helping them like that and showing the cases or just helping them and giving any statement over there, definitely you would be defamed. You would be defamed and the law of court will show the case against you that you are not having the proper knowledge and you are not eligible as the doctor. Okay, so that's why this kind of signs are very important as the scar. Next one, the tattoo mark. Yes, so many times we have seen the, nowadays it is actually the fashion for the person, they are having the tattoo mark. But sometimes not it is the fashion, sometimes people are just hiding their, intaking this kind of, any kind of drugs and all. Even sometimes the cocaine people, who are, whenever they are actually introducing the cocaine and all, that time also some shots, there's signs also we are getting over the dorsum of the palm and all. So that's why it should be very much cautious. Whenever the person is coming along with the tattoo, you have to ask, you have to check properly. Even it is showing their mental conditions, their religions, everything. So in that cases, you have to write down, because if the next day, due to the excess amount of the drug invasion, the person is getting diet and they are starting to raise the question due to your medicine, actually the person got expired, then you actually may produce your all the evidence that what you are having, okay? So actually still so many things are remaining. I'm just making it shortened. Identification mark, that's what I'm going to tell. That is also very important. If the patient is having any kind of moles or any kind of pigmented or any birthmark, everything, that also you have to write down, because sometimes what happened, you have given some medicine to someone and it has been started to take some other people. These people actually got diet and all the problems came, all the case actually shoot for you only. So in that cases, you may tell, no, those two persons are entirely different. I have given this medicine to that person, not this one. So like that, some problem may arise. So just to identity crisis, to avoid this kind of problem, this kind of things should be written or documented properly. Yes, dying declaration usually not coming to us, but most of the cases it has been seen, any person who is tormented by their family persons or any burn cases or any poisoning cases, usually before dying, whatever their declarations, that is actually recorded by the magistrate along with sometimes the police and all. So it is also important for most of the cases of modern people. Time of death and the post-mortem, definitely time of death we are going to see for the actually the there now several slides, so I just making it a little bit small, because in future if it is possible I'll continue the same thing descriptively, because today another program is still remaining, that is valedictory program. So I'm just making it very short. So I think this time of death and post-mortem portions also I'll be telling some days if it is possible. Next one, that is the another different forensic findings we are getting. They are also just shortly I'm telling, this is the video I have put. You may people can see this bright came, and then it is actually the hit and run case in case of the transportation injury. It has been seen there is the chances of the hit and run cases. They are actually victims are getting, definitely their head injury is the one of the cause, one of the leading of their death or sometimes their injury. But it has been seen whenever the crash along with two vehicles is occurring, other person usually escaping the place or they are not getting injured like that, okay? And in case of the head injury also, when they are falling from heights, this is also very, very important. It has been seen that actually what kind of injury occurred, that is there is having any suicidal or homicidal attempt, that also can be understood by the checking of their grips. Because before doing any kind of falling from height due to any homicidal cases and all, there is a chances of the foreign bodies which is remaining the body of the victims, some linen, some cloths, some buttons or some hair particles of the other person. This is also very important. In case of gunshot injury, that is also their videos I have shown there. Also, it is very important that the gun, the injury, always there is having some exit and entry point. Exit point is always would be very much larger than the entry point. So whenever we are seeing the exactly the gunpowders along with their the lacerated wounds, it is actually from the behind and it is smaller than the exit point, then we have to be very much cautious that this person if we are going to be very much cautious that so there definitely will be the strong this ligature mark, and whatever the their hyoid bones, there is a chances of the broken hyoid bones and all. Not only that, there is a chances of the frothing and sometimes their dilated pupils, and definitely the dripping of the saliva from the angle of the mouths. Okay, and like that conditions we may get, but always keep in mind sometimes after killing somewhere else, then just framing the case act like the suicidal hanging, that's also may occur. For that also, what happened, the exactly their hand grips will be checked. If there is having any foreign bodies, any hairs or anything like that, any presence of any defensive mark, because for the defensive purpose, there is a chances of the another another scratch and all. Even sometimes by intoxicating the person, then only the ligature is just wrapping surrounding the necks, and then afterwards it is actually suspended from the height. Okay, not only that, even in case of the hanging, whenever it is actually occurring the mechanical, not by any homicidal case, this had been seen that is the presence of the feces, urine, okay, sometimes semen, and also that's also normally releasing for the asphyxial conditions. Even the strangulation also, it has been seen there is a chances of the marks, but strangulation most of the cases it is homicidal. Okay, but suffocation and mechanical asphyxia also we are getting the same ligature mark, because but there is having another point, that is a hyoid bone fracture, we are not getting that much. And next of the thing, that is their subconjunctive hemorrhage is very much common in case of the suffocation and the mechanical asphyxia. In case of the drowning, definitely this is very, very important. Sometimes what happens, the people are accidentally drowning, sometimes homicidally, but forcefully by some people, actually the people are getting drowning. And sometimes what happens, sometimes it is suicidal attempt. Okay, suicidal is also occurring several times. But how to understand? Sometimes what happens for the in case of the homicidal, sometimes people they are usually it has been seen that after killing somewhere else, suddenly the dead body is just dumped inside some pond and all. So whenever the postmortem report is going through that time it has been seen there is a chances of the the entire the laryngeal spasm is not occurred like that, because already the person was dead. So laryngeal spasm or the presence of the fluid or the water inside the lung, which is causing the edematous lungs and all, even the frothing of the frothing from the lungs and the trachea and the bronchial portions, along with the staining of the mud, okay, during this drowning, usually people are trying to inhale properly. In that time, little bit water also started to introducing through the lungs, and that time it is also increasing their body weight, and the impulse of the coughing continuously, more water is increasing and introducing, and patient's weight becoming increased due to the specific gravity, patients are getting drawn. So in that cases also, you will not get this kind of presence of the water sometimes. And the portions also very less. Even sometimes the diatom, the one kind of algae, also we may see the presence in case of that. If there is having any chance of the suicidal or any kind of the, better to say, any accidental drowning. Even their hands also becoming fisherman like, they're for staying for a long inside the water. There is the chances of the this kind of wrinkles over the hands and all. But in case of the, I mean, any kind of murdering from somewhere else, suddenly throwing to the water, there is the chances not finding this kind of features and all. Okay. And besides that, different are also there. I'm not just going to tell little bit afterwards. I'm just going to end up this session. Especially the stab injury also very important, because it has been seen that most of the cases cut throat. Always be very much careful, that is cut throat, and the usually for the defensive mark over the wrist region. There, when the person is going to do this suicidal attempt, there would be definitely hesitation marks, several hesitation marks, because they always, whoever going to do this, I mean, this kind of suicide, always they are also having little bit compassion for their own life. So that's why that much confident they are not. That's why there is having the chances of the hesitation mark. One cut would be, might be deep, which is actually leading their death. But in case of the homicidal cases, it has been seen there is a chances of the several deep cut. Okay, and especially for the, usually for the neck also, it has been seen the exactly the cut is starting for the. I mean, who is doing the suicidal attempt, who is actually left right-handed, always the cut should be started from the left side to right side. But in case of the, I mean, of any kind of homicidal attempt, this kind of pattern would not be maintained. There with the cut directly, there is no actually the proper directions and all. Okay, in case of the burn case also, the last thing I'm just going to tell, in case of the burn case also, you may see that is sometimes when the person are doing any suicidal attempt, there is having some tendency to pour the kerosene, okay, just from the, I mean, just over the head. And usually as their mental preparation, they are blazing those matches and it is throwing towards their actually leg. No one having that much guts to give this, I mean, matches over there, directly over their head. No, very less case we are getting. Even most of the cases, it is very rare. But when there is having the tendency to do any, I mean, homicidal cases, most of the cases it had been seen, it should be, I mean, used just over the head to ensure the case very fast, to make it dead. So like that, several things are there, because I have omitted here several slides, because here before that, this superimposition technique, which nowadays that mutilated body part and the unidentified dead body, they are also, we are doing several computerized, again, these bony parts. Again, we are using some soft tissues to make this face again, okay, this contouration. And then we are trying to identify the patient. Like there's several things were there here, enter the lip print, hand print, and everything was there, how to do it and all. But time is short, so I'm leaving those topics. And the last one I'm just going to tell, and then I'll be going to finish. This forensic toxicology also very big entire topic, because for the arsenic also we have seen, it is also having the tendency to it is also getting just accumulated at the bulb of the hairs, sometimes in the bones. That's why arsenics, whenever we are giving to the patient, there is having the same like features, like, you know, this diarrhea, vomiting. So people couldn't understand there is having any foul game and all. But what happened after exhumations, after total cremation of the dead body also, arsenic may stay for a long. Yeah, even after becoming ashes also, it can stay inside these ashes. So that time, if you are going to check, definitely the case will be cracked. by any foul gas. Even selenium sulfate also using, where the slow poisoning, which actually continuously falling the hairs, body hairs, the everything, the vital, all activities getting, suddenly he got some expired and all. But if you are going through the entire case, you will see the actually slow poisoning is the one of the reason. Forensic laboratory, there are actually several type of DNA tests, even how the blood spurting, that is a big portion I already prepared, but time is less, I can't tell now. So this is also important, the blood matching of the criminal, sometimes the crime places that should be checked properly. This is the victim's blood or some others. Sometimes this DNA test also very, very important. Even light detector also sometimes using to detect the actual criminal from the place. And that, yes, forensic psychiatry actually very important thing, because there are several cases we have seen there. Actually, the person who is having some paranoid type of, conditions like some schizophrenia, like some autism also in case of small kids, that is not always it is the criminal activity is growing up, but sometimes if it is not treated properly, that is also may cause some different problems. Even here some this actually both are the nurse who has given actually killed more or less 100 people by giving the potassium cyanide, okay, through injections and all. And this lady actually just made the person's entire body mass to the, actually making the soap, okay, after making this fragrance, sometimes she made some cakes from the mass of the human being, some blood of the human being. So it is actually not the normal cases. Sometimes this kind of criminology we may see in case of such of the problem, like some obsessive disorder, OCD, sometimes sometimes bipolar disorder, sometimes it is not treated properly, that also may cause like that. Even this, in this case also, it is the entirely the paranoid schizophrenic case, where this person, where it is the victim, Tim McLean case, is 18 years boy. He had actually eaten by this necrophilic person. This is a Chinese person. He was just sitting and he just thought that someone is telling. In fact, this victim actually telling to him, please kill me. I want to be dead. Like that. So it is actually there. Nothing. It is actually the mental state where the people are having the tendency to have the hallucination, illusion, delusion. So in that, sometimes it has been seen the forensic psychiatry, whenever the patients are coming to us, that we have to check their mental state also. Okay, if you are getting the patient is excessive having such of the obsession, that time we may go, it can be called a different our disorders is the agroholagam mother and all, but we may give the further some medicines. We are having jashti madhu, we are having jata mangshi, then along with brahmi tagara, then another medicines like the manush mitra batakam, along with we may go for several drugs, especially the abhrak bhasma. It's also having very good effect over the entire brain and just making it a little bit calm and soothe. So whenever we are going for that, even for we are detecting any person having some behavioral problem or any mental problem, that time we should go for some therapies like Shirodhara, Shira Abhang. It is actually our duty to restrain the people from doing any kind of even any medical legal actions or any kind of criminal activities and all. So as being doctor also, we may restrict by giving the proper medications and proper psychological treatment. And as the conclusion, I want to say, yes, I think you people are knowing this person. He is Ayurvedic doctor. He had the degree BAMS like us, but still when Ayurvedic doctor becoming a serial killer or psychopath, then what would be the future of this society? Actually, we don't know. By the way, now I'm going to complete the session. Thank you so much. Thank you for the entire webinar 2020. Thanks a lot. Requesting all people, please kindly don't leave this session because now sir is going to start the valedictory program along with the thanks of vote of thanks.
Good evening everybody. First I congratulate all the listener, those who have listened carefully our today's session. So far my knowledge, the maximum or the all the participants, today's participants are from Bengal. So if you give me the permission, I can continue my session in Bengali.
Subho okay, Sarkar. No problem, sir.
Yes, sir.
Subho Sandha, Pratyekke Ami Asankho Dhonnobad, Antorik Shubhechha, Ebong Bhalobasha Janachi, Amar নিজের তরফ থেকে এবং আমাদের রাজীব গান্ধী আয়ুর্বেদিক কলেজ ও হাসপাতালের পক্ষ থেকে আমাদের কলেজের মাননীয় সেক্রেটারি মহাশয় মিস্টার একে রায় উনি বলেছিলেন যে ডক্টর মণ্ডল আমি চেষ্টা করব থাকতে আপনার ভ্যালিডেক্টরি সেশনে যে কোনো কারণে হোক উনি হয়তো যোগ দিতে পারেননি তবে উনি বলেছিলেন আমি যদি না পারি আপনি আমার হয়ে প্রত্যেককে অভিনন্দন জানাবেন আমরা ওয়েবিনার 2020 আজকে সমাপ্তি ঘোষণা করলাম কিন্তু একই সাথে আপনাদের আরো জানিয়ে রাখি যে আগামী দিনে আমাদের এই কলেজের এই যে ওয়েবিনার বা ওয়েব সেমিনার আমরা কিন্তু কন্টিনিউ করব এবং আমরা আশা করব আপনারা আমাদের আগামী দিনে যে সমস্ত অনুষ্ঠান হবে সেখানে এইভাবে সক্রিয়ভাবে উপস্থিত থেকে আমাদের আরো বেশি এগিয়ে যেতে সাহায্য করবেন করোনা আর কোভিড 19 আজকে আমাদের সমস্ত পৃথিবীকে ঘরবন্দী করে ফেলেছে আমরা দীর্ঘ প্রায় 7 থেকে 8 মাস প্রত্যেকই গৃহবন্দী খুব জরুরি প্রয়োজন ছাড়া কেউই আমরা বাইরে বের হচ্ছি না তো সেই পরিপ্রেক্ষিতে আমাদের বিশেষ করে শিক্ষা ব্যবস্থা আর স্কুল কলেজ পুরোপুরি বন্ধ তাহলে সমস্ত শিক্ষা প্রাঙ্গণ বন্ধ থাকার জন্য আমরা দেখছি এন্টায়ার এডুকেশন সিস্টেম নাও বেসড অন দিস অডিও ভিজুয়াল ওয়ে অর্থাৎ সমস্ত স্কুল কলেজ একদম প্রাইমারি লেভেল থেকে আমরা পোস্ট গ্রাজুয়েট লেভেল অবধি আমরা দেখছি যত স্কুল কলেজের ক্লাস সমস্ত কিছুই কিন্তু এই সেমিনারের মাধ্যমে হচ্ছে এবং পরীক্ষাও বেশ কিছু প্রতিষ্ঠানের বা বেশ কিছু ইউনিভার্সিটির এক্সামিনেশনও কিন্তু এই ওয়েবিনারের মাধ্যমেই বা অডিও ভিজুয়াল মাধ্যমে হচ্ছে জানি না কবে আমরা আবার অফলাইন ক্লাস বা বিদ্যালয়ে আমাদের পড়াশোনা শুরু করতে পারবো তো যতদিন পর্যন্ত আমরা আমাদের এই অফলাইন ক্লাস যেটাকে আমরা বলি যে সামনাসামনি ছাত্র এবং শিক্ষকের মুখোমুখি যে ক্লাস ওপেন সেশন শুরু করতে না পারবো ততদিন পর্যন্ত আমরা কিন্তু এই অনলাইন ক্লাস এবং এই অনলাইন সেমিনার এই দুটোই আমরা কন্টিনিউ করে যাব আজকের এই যে সেমিনারের ভ্যালিডেক্টরি বা সমাপ্তি ভাষণ দিতে আমি বসেছি এটার আমি একটা জাস্ট খুব সংক্ষিপ্ত একটা একটু বিবরণ দিই যে কি কেন আমি হঠাৎ করে এটাতে शुरू कर लगे कलेज तरफ थे देखल सारा भारतवर्षे सारा पृथ्वी विशेषकर सारा भारतवर्षे विभिन्न शिक्षा प्रतिष्ठान आयुर्वेदिक शिक्षा प्रतिष्ठान तारा सेमिनार वेब सेमिनार नेशनल इंटरनेशनल लेवेले तारा चालू करेछे फेसबुकेर माध्यमे ह्वाट्सएपेर माध्यमे और विभिन्न इन्स्टाग्राम डिफरेंट जे समस्त एखन मीडिया आछे तार थेके आमरा आपनाराओ देखेछेन एबं आमिओ देखलाम जे सबाई एटा करछे तो आमराओ चिंता भावना शुरू करलाम जे जाते आमरा এটাকে করতে পারি আমাদের ক্ষমতা খুব সীমিত কারণ এটা একেবারেই আমরা প্রথম শুরু করেছি আমাদের এটা একটা মেডিকেল ইনস্টিটিউট এবং আমাদের কলেজের অবস্থান হচ্ছে একটা ইন্টেরিয়র গ্রামের মধ্যে সেখান থেকে কলেজ থেকে এটাকে কন্ডাক্ট করা টু মাচ ডিফিকাল্ট তাহলে আমাকে যদি করতে হয় কলকাতার মধ্যে থেকে বা কলকাতার থেকেই এটাকে করতে হবে এবং বিভিন্ন জনকে আমাকে অ্যাসেম্বল করতে হবে এবং অ্যাসেম্বল করতে গিয়ে সবথেকে বড় প্রবলেম যেটা নেট ইন্টারনেটের প্রবলেম প্রত্যেকের ক্ষেত্রেই আছে যারা স্পিকার তারা এবং যারা পার্টিসিপেন্ট অর্থাৎ লিসিনার যারা তারা প্রত্যেকেই কিন্তু দেখতে পাচ্ছেন যে আমরা প্রোগ্রাম করতে করতে মাঝে মাঝে আমাদের কিছু কিছু ইন্টারাপশন হয়েছে তার জন্য আমরা আন্তরিকভাবে দুঃখিত এবং সবার কাছে ক্ষমা প্রার্থী তো এটা শুরু করতে গিয়ে আমি আমার শিক্ষক শিক্ষক যারা আছেন শিক্ষক মণ্ডলীদের সাথে আমি আলোচনা করেছিলাম তারা প্রত্যেকেই এটাকে সমর্থন করেছিলেন কিন্তু তাদের মধ্যে আমার জুনিয়র একজন কলিগ ডক্টর প্রিয়াঙ্কা গাঙ্গুলী অ্যাসিস্ট্যান্ট প্রফেসর সোলো ডিপার্টমেন্ট ও সব থেকে বেশি উৎসাহ নিয়ে এবং হোল হার্টেডলি এটাকে অ্যাকসেপ্ট করেছিল এবং ও বলেছিল স্যার আপনি শুরু করুন আমি আপনার সাথে আছি তো শুরু করার সময় আমার সাথে কিন্তু খুব কমজনই ছিল এখন যেমন আমি অনেককেই সাথে পেয়েছি অনেকেই আমরা জানি যে কোনো একটা জিনিস শুরু করতে গেলে একজন বা দুজন শুরু করে তারপরে আস্তে আস্তে সেখানে এসে জয়েন করে প্রথম দিকে অনেকেই সন্দেহ প্রকাশ করেছিল যে আমরা আদৌ এটাকে কন্টিনিউ করতে পারবো কি না কিন্তু আপনাদেরকে আমি বলছি যে আমরা অনেক মানে বাধা বিপত্তি বা বিঘ্ন হওয়া সত্ত্বেও আমরা কিন্তু আজকে শেষ দিনে এসে উপনীত হয়েছি গত পাঁচ তারিখ দ্যাট ইজ দ্য ন্যাশনাল টিচার্স ডে জাতীয় শিক্ষক দিবসের দিনেই আমরা এই প্রোগ্রাম শুরু করেছিলাম এবং যখন আমি ছিলাম প্রথম স্পিকার এবং ইনাগুরেটার তো প্রথম দিন আমি শুরু করার সময় আমার নিজেরই একটা সন্দেহ ছিল যে শুরু তো আমি করলাম শেষ করতে পারবো তো লোখাসি হবে না কারণ এমনিতেই বেঙ্গলে আয়ুর্বেদের কন্ডিশন খুবই পুয়োর তার মধ্যে আমার কলেজ প্রাইভেট কলেজ এমনিতেই আমরা অনেকখানি পিছনে রান করি আমরা সবসময় ব্যাক বেঞ্চার বিশেষ করে আমি তোমরা ছাত্র যারা আছে বা আরো যারা আছে আজকে এখানে ডিগনিফাইড পার্সন যারা এটা শুনছেন তারাও জানেন যে আমি কলেজের বিভিন্ন সমস্যা নিয়ে যেভাবে ভুক্তভোগী বা লড়াই করি তাতে আমার মাঝে মাঝে মনে হয় যে প্রাইভেট কলেজ মানে কি এটা কি কোনো শিক্ষা প্রতিষ্ঠান নয় এর কি কোনো গুরুত্ব নেই এখানে যারা পড়াশোনা করে তারা কি স্টুডেন্ট নয় মাঝে মাঝে আমার নিজের ওপরেই রাগ হয় কিন্তু কি করব আবার আমি নিজের দুঃখ নিজের মনে চেপে নিয়েই আবার আগে বা অগ্রসর হতে থাকি তো সেই অগ্রসর হতে গিয়ে আমি দেখেছি আমাদের কলেজ শুরু হয়েছে 2002-এ তারপরে বহু উত্থান পতনের সাক্ষী আমি এই কলেজের আজকে একটা জায়গায় আমরা এসে দাঁড়িয়েছি এবং বলতে বাধা নেই যে ইস্টার্ন জোনে গতদিনে প্রফেসর ডক্টর তুহিন কান্তি বিশ্বাস বলেছিলেন সেদিন আমার কিন্তু খুব ভালো লেগেছিল উনি বলেছিলেন যে এটা একটা দারুণ উদ্যোগ এবং ইস্টার্ন জোনে সর্বপ্রথম আমরাই কিন্তু এই আয়ুর্বেদিক ফিল্ডে আমি অন্যান্য ফিল্ডে যাচ্ছি না বা অন্যান্য ফিল্ডে আমি তুলনা করতে যাব না আমরা আয়ুর্বেদিক ফিল্ডে আমরা কিন্তু ইনস্টিটিউশনালি সর্বপ্রথম এই ওয়েব সেমিনারটা আমরা চালু করেছি, এবং শুধু চালু করা নয়, যথেষ্ট গর্বের সাথে এবং যথেষ্ট সাকসেসের সাথেই কিন্তু আমরা সেটাকে কমপ্লিট করেছি। তো সেই কমপ্লিট করতে গেলে শুধু তো আমার একার দ্বারা বা ইনস্টিটিউশনের দু একজনের দ্বারা তো হবে না, এখানে প্রত্যেকেই যারা লিসনার ছিলেন তারা এবং পার্টিসিপেন্ট যারা স্পিকার, আমরা চেষ্টা করেছি ভারতবর্ষের বিভিন্ন ইনস্টিটিউশনের যারা কোয়ালিফাইড পার্সন আছে তাদের সাথে কন্ট্যাক্ট করে, এবং উইদিন শর্ট পিরিয়ডে আমরা বেশ কিছু ভালো ভালো স্পিকারকে আমরা পেয়েছি এবং তাদের মূল্যবান বেশ কিছু ওপিনিয়ন আমরা শুনেছি। প্রথম স্পিকার যদিও আমি ছিলাম, আমি ইনাগুরেট করেছিলাম, আমার পরে ডক্টর প্রসেনজিৎ চ্যাটার্জি ক্যান্সার বিশেষজ্ঞ ছিলেন, এবং ওনার বক্তব্য আমার মনে হয়নি যে কারো কাছে দুর্বোধ্য বা জটিল হয়েছে। ক্যান্সার চিকিৎসার উনি আমাদের কাছে একটা নতুন দিগন্ত খুলে দিয়েছেন। আমি অন্তত মনে করি যারা এই দুদিন ওনার কাছে এই লেকচার শুনেছেন তারা অন্তত বেশ কিছু নতুন তথ্য পেয়েছেন। ক্যান্সার যদি আমাদের আয়ুর্বেদে আমরা খুব একটা বেশি অভিজ্ঞ নই, আমরা রুগী পেলেও আমরা হয়তো কেউ কেউ টুকটাক চিকিৎসা করে, কিন্তু বেশিরভাগই আমরা কেমোথেরাপি বা রেডিওথেরাপি এই সমস্ত আমরা রেফার করে দিই, আমরা চিকিৎসা করি না। কিন্তু রোগটা হলে কি করতে হবে বা কি কি কারণে হয় সেটা কিন্তু উনি এত সুন্দরভাবে প্রাঞ্জলভাবে আমাদের সামনে ব্যাখ্যা করেছেন যে আনএক্সপ্লেনেবল। আমার তো মনে হয় যে এত সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা আমি এর আগে শুনিনি। আমি বহু জায়গায় বহু সেমিনার অ্যাটেন্ড করেছি ভারতবর্ষের বিভিন্ন জায়গাতে, তো উনি যেভাবে সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছিলেন গতদিনে এবং দুটো সেশনেই উনি, তাতে আমার মনে হয় আপনারা বা আমরা প্রত্যেকেই উপকৃত হয়েছি। তারপর নেক্সট ছিলেন আমাদের ডক্টর সুমন সরকার, উনি এক সল্লে এমডি এবং উনি একসময় আমাদের কলেজেও শিক্ষক হিসাবে যুক্ত ছিলেন, পরে উনি গভর্নমেন্ট সার্ভিসে জয়েন করেছেন। ডক্টর অচিন্ত মিত্র, উনিও একদম ফার্স্ট পার্ট অফ আওয়ার কলেজ, কলেজ যখন এস্টাবলিশ হয় আমাদের প্রথম উনি শিক্ষক হিসাবে আমাদের কলেজে ছিলেন, আমাদের সাথেই ছিলেন বেশ কিছুদিন, তারপর উনি আমাদের কলেজ ছেড়ে সরকারি চাকরিতে চলে গেছেন। বাইরের স্পিকারদের মধ্যে ছিলেন ডক্টর তুহিনকান্তি বিশ্বাস, উনি তার আগে আমি বলি যে ডক্টর অচিন সুমন সরকারের শল্য চিকিৎসাতে পাইলস বা অর্শ যেটাকে আমরা বলি সেটাকে কত সহজভাবে চিকিৎসা করা যায়, বা ফরেন বডি যেটাকে আমরা ব্রণ চিকিৎসা বলি, ব্রণ মিনস আলসার, আলসারকে কিভাবে আয়ুর্বেদিক পদ্ধতিতে চিকিৎসা করা যায় উনি সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছিলেন। অচিন্ত মিত্র ওয়ান অফ দ্য বেস্ট রিসার্চার অ্যাট দিস প্রেজেন্ট মোমেন্ট ইন ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল। আয়ুর্বেদ নিয়ে যে সমস্ত রিসার্চ হচ্ছে আমাদের বেঙ্গলে শুধু নয়, সারা ভারতবর্ষে যত যে সমস্ত রিসার্চার যারা আছেন, আমরা যদি বলি চিকিৎসা বিজ্ঞানী, তাদের মধ্যে অচিন্ত মিত্র কিন্তু ওয়ান অফ দেম। উনি টিসিআরএসে কাজ করেন এবং সেখানে বিভিন্ন ড্রাগ নিয়ে সেখানে রিসার্চ হয়, ড্রাগ মিনস ডিফারেন্ট মিনারেল আইটেম, হার্বাল আইটেম, সেখানে ইন্ডিভিজুয়ালি অর জয়েন্টলি তাদের মেডিসিনাল এফিকেসি, তাদের স্ট্যান্ডার্ডাইজেশন এবং তাদের রিমুভ পয়জনাস এফেক্ট রিমুভ করা, এই যে সমস্ত একটা ড্রাগকে আমি সিলেক্ট করলাম, সেই ড্রাগটাকে আমরা চরক বা সুশ্রুত বা বাগভট্টে আমাদের যে সমস্ত সংহিতা আছে সেখানে আমরা দেখেছি যে বিভিন্ন ঔষধি দ্রব্যের নাম লেখা আছে এবং তাদের ব্যবহার বিধি লেখা আছে। কিন্তু লেখা শুধু থাকলেই হবে না, সেটাকে প্র্যাকটিক্যাল ইমপ্লিমেন্টেশন করতে গেলে মডার্ন অ্যাসপেক্টে আমাকে মানুষের কাছে তুলে ধরতে হবে, আদারওয়াইজ কিন্তু মানুষ খাবে না। তাহলে তার আইডেন্টিফিকেশন করা যে এই হার্বসটা সত্যি একটা আমলকি আর এটা হরিতকি আর এটা ব্রাহ্মী এবং এটার মধ্যে কোনো পয়জনাস আইটেম নেই, কারণ আমরা জানি যে এখন যে কোনো জায়গা থেকে কোনো দ্রব্য আমরা যদি কালেকশন করি সে কালেকশন করলে সেটার কিন্তু টক্সিসিটি ফ্রি ফাস্ট করতে হবে, কারণ আমরা জানি যে যে কোনো জায়গা থেকেই কিন্তু হার্বস কালেকশন করা যায় না। আমাদের আয়ুর্বেদিক যে ফার্মাকোপিয়া আছে বা দ্রব্যগুণ আছে সেখানে দ্রব্য সংগ্রহের বিধি আছে, দ্রব্য সংগ্রহ বিধি, কিভাবে দ্রব্য সংগ্রহ করতে হয়, কোথা থেকে সংগ্রহ করতে হয়, কিভাবে করতে হয়, সেগুলো সবই লেখা আছে। কিন্তু সেইগুলোকে আমি যদি মডার্ন সায়েন্টিফিক প্যারামিটার দিয়ে এস্টাবলিশ না করি তাহলে কিন্তু বর্তমানে তার অ্যাকসেপ্টেন্সই পাবো না। তো সেই জন্য ডক্টর অচিন্ত্য মিত্র খুব সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছেন যে একটা ওষুধকে কিভাবে আমরা রোগের উপযোগী হিসাবে উপস্থাপিত করতে পারি, সুন্দরভাবে উনি ব্যাখ্যা করে দিয়েছেন তা কত ডোজ হতে পারে এই সমস্ত নিয়ে। নেক্সট আমার ডক্টর তুহিন কান্তি বিশ্বাস আউটার যারা ছিলেন, তুহিন কান্তি বিশ্বাস নো ডাউট মোস্ট লার্নেড অ্যান্ড এডুকেটেড পার্সন, হি ইজ ওয়ান অফ দ্য মোস্ট এনথুয়াস্টিক আয়ুর্বেদিক রিসার্চার ইন বেঙ্গল। উনি আয়ুর্বেদ চিকিৎসার একটা নতুন দিগন্তের কথা আমাদের সামনে তুলে ধরেছেন। আমরা জেনেটিক মেডিসিনের কথা কিন্তু শুনে আসছি মডার্ন মেডিসিনে, এখন জেনেটিক মেডিসিন নিয়ে অনেক আলোচনা হচ্ছে। তো সেই জেনেটিক মেডিসিন যে আমাদের আয়ুর্বেদে আছে হিডেন, আমাদের আয়ুর্বেদ যে অলরেডি ডেসক্রাইবড, প্রকৃতি আমরা সবাই জানি যে প্রকৃতিটা কিন্তু আর কিছুই নয়, প্রকৃতি ইজ ইকুয়াল টু, আমরা এটাকে কোয়েনসাইজ করতে পারি জিনের সাথে। জিন যেমন 23 জোড়া জিন আছে, তার মধ্যে 23 এর মধ্যে 22 মেনলি দ্যাট ইজ 23 সেক্স ক্রোমোজোম, XXXY টা ফিক্সড, এর কোনো চেঞ্জ নেই। বাট আদার যে 22টা ক্রোমোজোম আছে, এই যে ক্রোমোজোমগুলো এটা কিন্তু এর ইননিউমারেবল অসংখ্য রকমের ভ্যারাইটি আছে। মাল্টিপ্লিকেশন আমরা যদি করি, পারমুটেশন কম্বিনেশন করলে কত অসংখ্য লোকের যে মানুষ হতে পারে, আমরা দেখেছি যে পৃথিবীতে আমরা অ্যাপারেন্টলি আর একই রকম দেখতে, কিন্তু আমরা যদি তাদের আরএনএ ডিএনএ বিশ্লেষণ করি সেখানে কিন্তু আমরা অল আর ডিফারেন্ট, আমরা কেউ সেম নই। তো অ্যাকর্ডিং টু আওয়ার প্রকৃতি, আমাদের প্রকৃতি কিন্তু এটা বহু দিন আগে, আমাদের চরক বা সুশ্রুত বহু দিন আগে, আজ থেকে 1500-2000 বছর আগে, আমরা যদি অথর্ববেদকে ধরি তাহলে আজ থেকে 1500 বছর আগে এই কনসেপ্ট, এবং চরক মোরাললেস চরক অরিজিনাল চরক ফার্স্ট এসক্রাইব হয়েছিল 1000 BC, এবং এখন যে চরকটা আমরা পাই সেটা 400 BC-তে এটা রিডাক্টেড হয়েছিল দিরাবল দ্বারা। তো তাহলে এই যে তখন খ্রিস্টের জন্মের পূর্ব থেকেই আমরা কিন্তু জানি যে প্রত্যেক মানুষ আলাদা আলাদা, আমরা অ্যাপারেন্টলি এক হলেও, এবং সেইটা যে চিকিৎসা বিজ্ঞানের মধ্যে আয়ুর্বেদও যে সেটাকে আছে, সেই জেনেটিক মেডিসিন কিন্তু উনি সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছেন। নেক্সট আমাদের বাইরের যারা আমি আগে বলিনি, ডক্টর এস সুভাষ, উনি ও চিকিৎসা বিজ্ঞানী, CCRS সল্টলেকে যুক্ত আছেন, যদি ওনার টপিক ছিল খুবই ছোট্ট এবং শর্ট, উনি খুব অল্প সময় বলেছিলেন, অল্প সময়ের মধ্যেই কিন্তু উনি জাস্ট ফান্ডামেন্টাল কনসেপ্ট অফ দ্রব্যগুণা, দ্রব্যগুণ জিনিসটা কি, এখানে কি আছে, কি দ্রব্যগুণ সাবজেক্টটা, তার ইম্পর্টেন্স কি, উনি কিন্তু অল্প সময়ের মধ্যেই খুব সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছিলেন। নেক্সট যে দুজন আমরা আমাদের বেঙ্গলের বাইরে থেকে আমরা যে দুজনকে পেয়েছিলাম, ডক্টর এস সুব্রহ্মণ্যম, উনি মেনলি দ্রব্যগুণ নিয়েই বলেছিলেন, এবং দ্রব্যগুণ সাবজেক্ট যে কতখানি ব্যাপক হতে পারে গ্রিন ফিজিওলজি নিয়ে উনি বলেছেন যে দ্রব্যগুণ সাবজেক্টটা কি, সেটা ওনার লেকচার না শুনলে কিন্তু আমাদের কাছে অনেকটাই অজানা থেকে যেত। আমরা দ্রব্যগুণ পড়েছি, আমি যদিও দ্রব্যগুণে স্পেশালাইজড নই, বাট তবু আমাদের বেঙ্গলে যে দ্রব্যগুণের চর্চা হয় এবং বেঙ্গলের বাইরে যে দ্রব্যগুণ কতখানি অ্যাডভান্স হয়ে গেছে এবং দ্রব্যগুণ জিনিসটা কি আসলে, এটা কি নিয়ে ড্রিল করে, সেটা কিন্তু উনি সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছেন। এর ব্যাপকতা কতখানি এবং মডার্ন অ্যাসপেক্টে আমাদের দ্রব্যগুণ সাবজেক্ট গাছপালা কতখানি মানুষের সাহায্যে আসতে পারে বা সাহায্য করতে পারে এই বর্তমান পরিস্থিতিতে, শুধু কোভিডে নয়, কোভিড আজ হয়েছে কাল থাকবে না, বাট আয়ুর্বেদ থাকবে, আয়ুর্বেদ ছিল থাকবে, আয়ুর্বেদ শাশ্বত অনাদিত্য আমরা জানি, ইটারনাল এন্ডলেস, তাহলে আয়ুর্বেদে আছে, ছিল, থাকবে। তো সেই জন্য সেই দ্রব্যগুণ সাবজেক্ট উনি কিন্তু ব্যাখ্যা করেছিলেন। নেক্সট স্মিতা ভাট, স্বাস্থ্যবিত্ত সাবজেক্ট নিয়ে উনি বলেছেন যে স্বাস্থ্যবিত্ত আমরা পড়েছি, স্বাস্থ্যবিত্তের উনি যেভাবে সুন্দরভাবে ব্যাখ্যা করেছেন পার্টিকুলার পয়েন্ট ধরে ধরে, যে আমরা যে সমস্ত বিশেষ করে আহার দ্রব্য খাওয়ার ব্যাপারে এবং আইডেন্টিফিকেশন মেনলি ইউটেন্সিল, আমার সব থেকে ভালো লেগেছে, আপনাদের আমি জানি না কোনোটা ভালো লাগবে কিনা, যে আমরা যে পাত্রগুলোতে খাই সে পাত্রগুলোর যে এত ভালো এফিকেসি আছে এবং সেগুলো শাস্ত্রে দেয়া আছে, আমরা কিন্তু কেউই এত গভীরভাবে কেউই আজ অব্দি স্টাডি করিনি। যে ডিফারেন্ট আইটেমে ডিফারেন্ট পাত্রের ওপরে আমরা জানি ডিফারেন্ট কাল বা ডিফারেন্ট কোয়ান্টিটিতে খেলে তার অষ্টবিধ আহার আয়তন চরক বলেছেন, যে সংযোগ বিরুদ্ধ প্রকৃতি বিরুদ্ধ এরকম বিভিন্ন রকম ভাবে চরক ডিটেলস বলে গেছেন, কিন্তু সেখানে যে পাত্র ইউটেন্সিল, যে সমস্ত পাত্রে আমরা খাবারগুলো খাই সে পাত্রগুলোর যে একটা স্পেশাল ইন্ডিকেশন আছে, এটা কিন্তু আমার, আমি শুনেছিলাম বা কিছু কিছু, আমার কাছে কোনো সঠিক রেফারেন্স ছিল না। তাহলে এই যে ছোট ছোট জিনিসগুলো আমরা যেগুলো জেনেছি, আরেকজন আমাদের বাইরের, যদিও উনি একসময় আমাদের কলেজেই ছিলেন, ডক্টর রমেন সাঁতরা, যোগ ব্যায়ামের উপরে উনি খুব সুন্দর ডেমনস্ট্রেশন দিয়েছেন যে বর্তমান শুধু কোভিডে নয়, কোভিডের জন্যই যে উপকারী তা নয়, যে যোগ ব্যায়াম বলতে আমরা যেটা বুঝি যে যোগ মানে বিরাট কিছু একটা কঠিন জিনিস, সেটা কিন্তু নয়। উনি খুব সহজ বেশ কিছু যোগ আমাদেরকে নিজে হাতে কলমে করিয়ে দেখিয়ে দিয়েছেন, যে যোগ ব্যায়ামগুলো করলে শুধু করোনা তো নয়ই আমরা সবসময় সুস্থ থাকব। এবং যোগ, আমার যতটুকু আইডিয়া আমি জানি, যোগ কিন্তু শুধুমাত্র একটা কিছু ফিজিক্যাল পশ্চার নয়, যে ফিজিক্যাল পশ্চার করে আমি কিছু বডি বিল্ড করলাম, সেটা কিন্তু যোগ নয়, যোগ একটা আলাদা জিনিস। তাহলে সেই যোগ, যে কেউ শুধুমাত্র কিছু কি বলে ডাম্বেল ভাঁজলো, ডন বৈঠক করলো, করে একটা বিরাট বড় বডি বানিয়ে ফেললো, মাসেল বানিয়ে ফেললো, সেটা কিন্তু যোগ নয়, যোগ একটা আলাদা জিনিস। সেই যে অষ্টাঙ্গ যোগ, আমরা জানি অষ্টাঙ্গ আয়ুর্বেদ, ঠিক একইভাবে অষ্টাঙ্গ যোগ জিনিসটা কি এবং সেটা আমরা রেগুলার যে কোনো কমন পিপল সে ঘরে বসেই ওটাকে প্র্যাকটিস করতে পারে, এবং সে যোগের যে ইম্পর্টেন্স বা তার যে বেনিফিশিয়াল এফেক্টগুলো নিতে পারে সেটা কিন্তু উনি খুব ভালোভাবে দেখিয়েছেন। নেক্সট আরেকজন বাইরের ছিলেন ডক্টর বিজয়ানন্দ মুখার্জি, উনি বাঙালি, এখন উনি আছেন বেনারস হিন্দু ইউনিভার্সিটিতে শালক্যতন্ত্রের এইচওডি। আমার সব থেকে খারাপ লেগেছে আজকে শেষ দিনে, মানে যদিও বলা উচিত নয় তবু আমি বলতে বাধ্য হচ্ছি, যে এই লেভেলের একজন স্পিকারকে আনতে গেলে যে এফোর্ট করতে হয় সেটা আমরা ওনাকে কিন্তু খুব সহজেই পেয়েছিলাম, এবং পাওয়ার পরে ওনার একটা বিরাট এক্সপেকটেশন ছিল, যে অনেক হয়তো স্টুডেন্টরা, আমি ওনাকে বলেছিলাম যে আমাদের সব স্টুডেন্টরা শুনবে, যে বিরাই বা কাঁতি সবাই শুনবে আপনার লেকচার, উনি সেই স্টুডেন্টদের উপযোগী করেই, সিলেবাস উপযোগী করেই উনি ওনার লেকচারটা বানিয়েছিলেন, কিন্তু আনফর্চুনেটলি আমার কলেজের স্টুডেন্টরাও ছিল না, অন্য কলেজ তো ছেড়েই দিলাম। আমি বুঝতে পারলাম না যে কেন আমার স্টুডেন্টরা হঠাৎ করে ওনাকে, ওনার লেকচারটা শুনলেন না। আমার দুর্ভাগ্য যে আমি এত বড় মাপের একজন শিক্ষা এডুকেশনিস্টকে আমাদের মধ্যে পেয়েও সেটাকে আমি ইউটিলাইজ করতে পারলাম না। নেক্সট, এরপর আসি আমার কলেজের যে সমস্ত স্পিকার ছিলেন, ডক্টর রিতেশ গিরি, দ্রব্যগুণের রিতেশ, যদিও টপিকসটা ছিল একটা বিরাট, ও একটা বিরাট বড় ব্রড স্পেকট্রামে শুরু করেছিল, হয়তো প্রথম এটা ফার্স্ট ট্রাই, সেই জন্য মানুষ ট্রায়াল অ্যান্ড এররের মাধ্যমেই শেখে, ভুল না করলে শিখবে না। বিশেষ করে ওয়েব সেমিনারে আমি রিতেশকে বলবো যে ওয়েব সেমিনারের পক্ষে কিন্তু এত বড় টপিকস উপযুক্ত নয়। ও বলতে চেয়েছিল অনেক কিছু, বিরাট বড় আমাকে দেখিয়েও ছিল, ওকে আমি বলেছিলাম যে এত বড় টপিকস কিন্তু ওয়েব সেমিনারে বলা যায় না। ওয়েব সেমিনার হচ্ছে খুব জিস্ট ফর্মে বলতে হয়, আমরা যদিও এখানে 1 ঘন্টা 1.5 ঘন্টা 2 ঘন্টা করে টাইম কনজিউম করছি, বাট ওয়েব সেমিনার কিন্তু খুব মিনিমাম, এটাতে ম্যাক্সিমাম হয়তো 40 মিনিট বা 1 ঘন্টার ভেতরে কিন্তু স্পিচটা কমপ্লিট করতে হয়। আমি জাস্ট একটা কথা এই প্রসঙ্গে না বলে পারছি না, আমার একজন শিক্ষক ছিলেন, এখন নেই, মারা গেছেন, ডক্টর সমর মিত্র, গ্রেট অ্যানাটমিস্ট, যার আমরা অ্যানাটমি বই পড়েছি। আমার সৌভাগ্য হয়েছিল স্যারের কাছে আমি টিউশনিও পড়েছিলাম এবং স্যার আমাদের MD লেভেলে স্যার আমাদের ক্লাসও নিতেন ফার্স্ট ইয়ারে শারীর সাবজেক্টে। তো স্যার বলেছিলেন যে ডক্টর কথার মানে কি, তার যেমন একটা ব্যাখ্যা দিয়েছিলেন, একইভাবে উনি শিক্ষকের একটা ব্যাখ্যা দিয়েছিলেন যে শিক্ষক অনেক জানতে পারে, অনেক কিছু জানে, যেমন ফিজিশিয়ান অনেক কিছু জানে, কিন্তু তার জ্ঞানটাই শ্রেষ্ঠ নয়, তাকে তার প্র্যাকটিক্যাল ইমপ্লিমেন্টেশন সে কতখানি করতে পারছে সেটাই কিন্তু তার যোগ্যতা নির্ধারণ করে। আমার নলেজ প্রচুর থাকতে পারে কিন্তু সেই নলেজকে যদি আমি ঠিক সময়ে ঠিকভাবে প্রয়োগ করতে না পারি তাহলে কিন্তু সেই নলেজ বৃথা আমার। তাহলে চিকিৎসক যদি ঠিক সময়ে ঠিক চিকিৎসা করতে না পারে তাহলে কিন্তু সেই চিকিৎসা বেকার, সে চিকিৎসক সঠিক চিকিৎসক নয়। ঠিক একইভাবে শিক্ষকের ক্ষেত্রেও স্যার বলেছিলেন যে শিক্ষকের যে টাইম শিডিউল আছে ওই 40 মিনিট বা 45 মিনিট যে ক্লাস, শিক্ষককে সেইভাবেই কিন্তু তার সাবজেক্টটা রেডি করতে হবে এবং ছাত্রকে ওই সময়ের মধ্যেই ছাত্রের মাথায় ঢোকাতে হবে, ওইটুকু সময়ের ভেতরে। আমার ক্ষেত্রে 45 মিনিট সময়, আমি 45 মিনিটের মধ্যেই কিন্তু আমি ছাত্রর উপযোগী, যে ছাত্র কিভাবে সেটাকে গ্রহণ করতে পারবে প্যালেটেবল যদি আমি বলি, তাহলে সেই 40 মিনিটের ভেতরেই কিন্তু আমাকে ছাত্রের মতো করে আমাকে ছাত্রের মাথায় ঢুকিয়ে দিতে হবে। আমি জানি বিরাট 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 তত্ত্ব আওড়ে বিরাট কিছু শুরু করলাম, বিরাট দিয়ে লাস্টটা শেষ করতে পারলাম না, সে মাঝ সমুদ্রে গিয়ে নৌকা ভেসে গেল, সেটা কিন্তু লাভ নেই। যে আমরা যদি ওয়ার্ক অ্যান্ড ফোর্স ফিজিক্সের যদি কোনো রুল ল ফলো করি যে কার্যর সংজ্ঞা কি, যে ফল লাভ না হলে কার্য নয়, সারাদিন দেয়াল ঠেলে ঘেমে নিয়ে হাত পা ছিঁড়ে বসে রইলাম, দেয়াল 1 ইঞ্চিও সরালো না, বাট একটা লোক সে সারাদিনে 100 ঝুড়ি মাটি বয়ে ফেললো বা জমি কুপিয়ে ফেললো, সে কিন্তু কাজ করলো, ফল পেলো। তো সেই জন্য আমি রিতেশের ব্যাপারে এই জন্যই বললাম যে রিতেশ চেষ্টা করেছে, সেই জন্য আমি তাকে এনকারেজ করছি। নেক্সট আমার অপরাজিতা দাস, ছষ্ঠবিত্তের, রসায়নের কি এফেক্ট, বিশেষ করে কোভিডের ক্ষেত্রে আমরা জানি যে রসায়ন একটা অষ্টাঙ্গ আয়ুর্বেদের একটা ব্রাঞ্চ। লাস্ট হচ্ছে জরা, সেই জরা টু ট্রিট, জরা ট্রিটমেন্ট করতে গেলে যে রসায়ন চিকিৎসা, এবং রসায়ন শুধুমাত্র যে জরা করে আমাদের, একই সাথে রসায়নের আরো একটা এফেক্ট হচ্ছে টু প্রোটেক্ট আওয়ার ইমিউনিটি অ্যান্ড এনহ্যান্স আওয়ার ইমিউনিটি, হুইচ ইজ মোস্ট এসেন্সিয়াল ইন প্রেজেন্ট সিচুয়েশন। যে আমাদের ইমিউনিটিটাকে বাড়াতে গেলে এবং সেই ইমিউনিটি প্রোটেকশন করতে গেলে আমাদের কি কি করা দরকার সেটা অপরাজিতা সুন্দরভাবে তুলে ধরেছে। আমি জানি না আমার ছাত্রদের কাছে বা যারা শুনেছেন তারা কার মধ্যে কতখানি উপযোগী হয়েছে। নেক্সট আমার কলেজের ডক্টর রুমা দে, কায় চিকিৎসা লেকচারার, ওনাকে হয়তো আমার ছাত্ররা সেইভাবে মরেছে, ম্যাডাম শুনছে তো, কোন ম্যাডামকে তো ইংলিশে বলতে হবে, ম্যাডাম স্মিতা ভাট জয়েন উইথ আস, ওয়েলকাম ম্যাডাম, বাট ফ্রম জাস্ট নাও ম্যাডাম ইজ নট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং দ্য বেঙ্গলি, সো আই নাও কনভার্টেড মাই লেকচার ইন ইংলিশ, ওয়েলকাম ম্যাডাম। we are the now last session in our valedictory session. Just I do Dr. Ruma Dek, assistant professor in our department of Kaya Chikitsa. She is very enthusiastic and energetic and dynamic. Maximum students are not meet with him because she is not able to take offline class till now. After joining her in our college, the college will college was locked down. So those the final year student already known his face. And next, Dr. Shilogna Bose, assistant professor in the department of Sarir Rachana. She explained the mental disease in our Ayurveda, how mental disease affect our health. And finally, our technical team, that is, it is my own abbreviation. I have designated the person, those who are honestly and heartily trying their best to complete or to success this seminar. Among them, I have already described Dr. Shilogna as Dr. Priyanka Ganguly, who have from the starting point and in the final last end point fully involved himself in this web seminar, and she trying her level best to fulfill or to mature this program. Adding with another three student of our third prof BMS, Sumit Kumar Mondol, Sankalan Bhattacharjo, and Rajendra Jana, they have started wholeheartedly or tried wholeheartedly to success this program. Although they are the medical student, but their knowledge are very much or not less than a engineering student or technical student. Sometimes I astonished to look after their knowledge in this software technology. I am the old age person. During our period, this web seminar or this type of software technology was not present. We are now just basically me. I regularly trying to learn something from WhatsApp, from Facebook, different type of concept are developed. And these three students, I personally and on behalf of our management, thankful to them and congratulate them for their wholehearted support. I hope in future I will get their participation in our college if we again organize such like of events. And our secretary personally told me that Dr. Mondol, don't stop this seminar, you continue it. Our management highly accepted and they appreciated. You know, now our management is a technical institute or engineering institute. They have so much developed in technology, but they congratulated me to see or to look after our webinar system. That technical team, technical team, personally I request them, sir, please look after our web seminar, one or two session. What is lacuna is present. Please suggest me. I will try to develop it. But they told me, principal sir, apnar seminar khub bhalo hocche. নেটের টেকনিক্যাল কিছু প্রবলেম আছে, আদারওয়াইজ আপনি যেভাবে করছেন এটা সত্যি মনেই হচ্ছে না যে এটা আপনার একদম আপনার কলেজের, এরা মেডিকেল স্টুডেন্ট আর আপনারা যারা মেডিকেল ফিল্ডে আছেন তারা এত সুন্দরভাবে এরকম ভাবে এটাকে এস্টাবলিশ বা প্রতিস্থাপিত উপস্থাপিত করতে পেরেছেন, আমাদেরকে যথেষ্ট ধন্যবাদ দিয়েছেন এবং এনকারেজ করেছেন। তাই আমি পুনরায় এই চারজনকে, দ্যাট ইজ আওয়ার কোঅর্ডিনেটর, টোটাল প্রোগ্রাম, নট অনলি কোঅর্ডিনেটর, অল আর কোঅর্ডিনেটর হিয়ার, দে আর আই জাস্ট গিভ দেম থ্রি স্টুডেন্ট দ্যাট ইজ টেকনিক্যাল মেম্বার, বাট সো ফার মাই নলেজ অল আর কোঅর্ডিনেটর, কোঅর্ডিনেটর মিনস সংযোগকারী, so all are we are coordinator. Basically I have not enough knowledge regarding this subject. I have theoretical knowledge, so I just put down them my concept to them, that is Priyanka and Sumit, Sankalan and Rajendra. Ami ei charjon ke amar concept ta just বলতাম ফোন করে যে আমি এরকম এরকম চাইছি, এইটা এটা করতে হবে, তোরা সঙ্গে সঙ্গেই সেটা নিয়ে কাজ শুরু করে দিত এবং সেটাকে কাজ শুরু করে ওরা রিপিটেডলি আমার কাছে পাঠিয়েছে, আমি ওদেরকে বকেছি ধমকেছি, অ্যাজ এ প্রিন্সিপাল ওরা কিছুটা মনক্ষুণ্ণ হয়েছে মাঝে মাঝে আমার উপরে, কিন্তু সেই মুহূর্তে আমার ভালো কাজ ওদের থেকে আদায় করার জন্য আমাকে একটু ওদের বকুনি দিতে হয়েছে, আদারওয়াইজ কিন্তু এত ভালো সুন্দর একটা প্রোগ্রাম আমরা আদায় করতে পারতাম না। সেই জন্য আমি জানি যে আমার আরো যারা স্টুডেন্ট আছে বা আরো শিক্ষক আছে তাদের মধ্যেও প্রতিভার অভাব নেই, অল আর কোয়ালিফাইড অ্যান্ড অল আর টেকনিক্যালি সাউন্ড, সো আই জাস্ট ইন মাই নেক্সট ওয়েব সেমিনার আই অফার টু মাই অল ফ্যাকাল্টিস মেম্বার অ্যান্ড ডিপার্টমেন্টাল ফ্যাকাল্টিস মেম্বার অ্যান্ড টু অল মাই স্টুডেন্টস দ্যাট দ্য নেক্সট সেমিনার উইল বি ওপেন টু অল। I just open the Pandora box or just I lighting the lamp. I mean, I shukra dilam, starting the program, web seminar. All are you welcome in our web seminar. You put down your suggestion, you put down your concept directly to me by phone or by mail. I will guide you. Any of our student, any of our staff, any of our teaching staff or any of our medical faculty, if anybody can accept or agree to prepare a topics, he or she can arrange a speaker, he himself present his opinion as a speaker, or he or she can arrange a speaker and inform me, sir, আমি এই একজনকে পেয়েছি যিনি রাজি হয়েছেন আমাদের এই ওয়েব সেমিনারে বলার জন্য এই ফিল্ডের, আমি তাকে অ্যাকসেপ্ট করে নিয়ে আমরা তার একটা সেমিনার আমরা অ্যারেঞ্জ করে দিতে পারবো, কারণ আমরা এখন অনেক টেকনিক্যালি সাউন্ড হয়ে গেছি, আমাদের কাছে এখন এটা খুব সহজ, ইট ইজ ভেরি মাচ ইজি টু আস, উইদিন ওয়ান ডেজ we can arrange a seminar and spread to our student society and our Ayurveda society. Just go to the certificate. Just to present the certificate. সার্টিফিকেট ফর অর্গানাইজার টিম এটা আমাদের হ্যান্ড ওভার করা হলো না, তুই তো তার আগে অফ করে দিলি বাবা। ইয়েস, দিস ইজ দ্য সার্টিফিকেট ফ্রম আওয়ার কলেজ অথরিটি টু দ্য কোঅর্ডিনেটর ডক্টর প্রিয়াঙ্কা গাঙ্গুলি। ইফ উই অর্গানাইজ ইট ইন অফলাইন দেয়ার উই হ্যান্ড ওভার ইট টু হারসেলফ অন দ্য স্টেজ, বাট ইট ইজ নট পসিবল অ্যাট দিস প্রেজেন্ট situation, so I just offer him, please take this certificate from our college and our management. I hand over this certificate to you. Next.
Thank you, ma'am. I said.
Next, certificate to Sumit Kumar Mondol, student of third professional BMS. I also congratulate him and hand over him a certificate as a technical member of this webinar 2020. I request Sumit Kumar Mondol, please accept the certificate. Next, Mr. Sankalan Bhattacharya. He is one of the active member or our active soldier. Not only member, but also they are the soldier, soinik. Ekta juddho korte gele jemon besh kichu active soldier lage, forefront soldier. Thik eki rokom amar forefront soldier jara tader moddhe Sankalan one of them. তা আমি তাকে রিকোয়েস্ট করছি, প্লিজ অ্যাকসেপ্ট দি সার্টিফিকেট ফ্রম মাইসেলফ অন বিহাফ অফ কলেজ অথরিটি। অ্যান্ড ফাইনালি রাজেন্দ্র জানা, হি ইজ ওয়ান অফ দ্য অ্যাক্টিভ সোলজার ইন দিস ইন আওয়ার প্রোগ্রাম। So I request Rajendra Jana to accept this certificate on behalf of our college. And before draw the conclusion, I just show the image of certificate of different participant and the speaker. So one of all are not ready at present. One of them here, Dr. Lecturer one, what is that name? It is the demo, unprinted, the name is not printed. So those who are participating as a speaker, they have got like this certificate. We will provide them through mail within a short period, within 13. We are trying our best, our technical team trying their great effort to send it within the stipulated period. And again, it is the participant delegate one, those who are the registered delegate, they have only received this certificate from our end. Their email already in our office book, we have sent this certificate individually. Within 30, all are get this certificate. So at the end of this program, finally I convey my best gratitude or heartfelt gratitude to all the speaker, to all the participants, to all the delegates for their active support to success, to grand success, our first attempt, that is first webinar 2020. And in this stage, I declare you with glad that we are again arrange our departmental seminar from the next month. It will inform you in the due time. All of you have got this information, and in this seminar we are trying to arrange some eminent figure in Ayurvedic field all over the India. From different institution and on different subject. Amra er pore next je seminar ta korbo, sei seminar e amra subject wise departmental seminar, and this departmental seminar conducted by our departmental teacher. And in this seminar, the subject expert mainly are from outside, and they are the eminent figure in the Ayurvedic field in the India. Not only India, some are internationally figure. We have already conducted 2 or 3 international figure of Ayurveda. Those who are very much popular about India, they are agreed with us to deliver their valuable speech in our web seminar platform. And it will start from 4th October. The time schedule and topics you have got within a short period in our official Facebook page. So hope again, we want your active participation in our future program. Om Shanti.
Okay, so our program is already finished yet. So the time came to say goodbye. And thank you so much for entire participations and all. Thanks a lot. Okay, good night.